There we go.
Running back.
Running back.
Yeah.
Okay, where we last left off, we were in Keaton's mines, on down around the third level, or headed down to the third level, possibly. You had to avoid dangers of collapsing tunnel walls and ceilings, and defeated two bands of monsters. You were directed here from the city or from the town of Kai, Akel. Cal, there we go, from a old gentleman who used to own the mines before he was caught in a cave-in. He said you might be able to find some adventure down here, so this is where we're at. And currently, I have you guys clustered around the shaft going down to the next level.
This is where adventure is. Get your path. Oh, sorry. You're still down here, huh? All right.
Had I finished dissolving the goblin that I was eating earlier?
Yes, he's all
Please do. He's
he's
absorbing
all
it entirely.
absorbed protein.
Excellent. See, you guys are gonna get hungry. You're gonna get adventuring for no food.
Oh, for the video, introduce yourselves again, guys.
I am Chroma. I'm a plasmoid monk sorcerer. And I like to take the shape of a young dragon.
I am Xanthia, Lady Five Fingers. I'm a human rogue with one appendage or one hand. The other one's missing somewhere.
I am Cladis Dradar, a blue dragonborn, and I recently went YOLO on a couple of goblins. So that was my most recent accomplishment.
That's kind of YOLO.
I'm Zorbon. I'm a warlock tiefling. That's it.
And Osvier has just sort of stepped off to the side. He will not be joining us in this game, so he just sort of
It's okay, we understand. We just found a
yeah,
shack.
he just sort of follows everyone around. He doesn't interact, but he's still there. So
Understandable after last time.
so what would you like to do next?
Maybe we should check to see if the elevator works.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, we can probably do that. Anybody want to come up with an idea how to get down there?
What's that?
I said, anybody want to do a roll and like find out how to get down there?
Thought we already got down there.
Nope, we haven't proceeded down to the next level yet. This is where we stop.
Can I roll, do an investigation roll on how to operate the lift to go down?
Absolutely.
Seventeen.
Well, the ropes look very sturdy. I say ropes, but they're more like cable. They're not metal, but they're definitely big, thick ropes. They seem rather still sturdy. And the mechanisms that control them seem to be okay. Do you have any mechanical abilities in your skills?
No,
Okay.
but I'll relay.
Okay, but as far as you can tell, it
I'll re
looks operational to the best of your knowledge.
Yeah. I'll relay that to everybody else, telling them that it looks like it's operational, but someone needs to figure out how to operate it.
Well,
I
appears.
obviously know how to do it. I'll do a roll. There we go. And what would that role be? To just investigate?
Yeah, just investigation.
Oh, that's 11.
Well, you found a couple of levers on the one side, so it obviously looks like it might be, it might need interaction from someone to operate the elevator, and they would have to stay here.
Do we?
Oh, I know. I use that.
Can I ascertain how deep?
Oh, you can't see the bottom. So.
Let's see. Can I roll an insight check on how to operate this mechanic?
Sure.
Okay. So that is a 11 plus 4, so 15.
Yep. It looks like those, it is controlled by those levers on the side by the one of the winches here.
Okay. How heavy would you, or how much force do you think I would have to exert to pull it? Does it seem rusted, or is it going to, like, glide pretty easily?
Well, it looks like it, there's no accumulated rust or dust. I mean, it's, of course, not clean, because it's been down here unattended for a while. But there does seem to be still grease in the gearing section, so it should work.
Okay, I'm going to, with my many, many voices of different pitches, tell everybody to get on the elevator.
Okay.
That's everybody on the bus.
Barbon walks over and stands on it.
I'm going to go get on the elevator as well, and then use Mage Hand to actuate the lever whenever everybody's on it.
Okay.
This is like what's it called, shit, like Indiana Jones with, like, hacking away at the bridge.
Alright, does my mage hand...
Yep, it clanks the lever and you guys start going down at a...
Click, 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 click.
Yeah,
click,
yeah, click, yeah, click. It's a pace. It's not a horrendous velocity, but it's not a crawling speed either, so you proceed downward. Rattling all the way down. At one point, there is a jerk and seems to teeter a little bit, and then there is a clank, and you proceed down further.
Okay.
Like maybe something was jamming in the cogs for a second.
Must have been a goblin skull.
Yeah.
Probably the one I
That's
killed
where I left
earlier.
It. Yeah. That's where we left it. Oh, whoops. Never mind. I'm still doing my monitor thing. So, do we make it down? Or
just about.
We get all wrecked.
I have a sound effect I was wanting to play. There it is.
Nice. Wilhelm scream. We definitely squashed somebody.
Did anyone hear Wilhelm?
Okay, so, yes.
Why was there a crunch when we landed?
Oh, don't worry, this is chips.
Okay, so...
Don't ask stupid questions.
Yeah. Yeah, let me change windows here. Or not windows, let me change scenes. Cancel. Stop streaming.
I think that's what I'll do. He's gonna be like fucking Drax because he's supposed to be simply off. So that's gonna be
okay. For a soundy bump and a bash, you reach your destination. The elevator kind of sits at an angle as the rope above you, starts starts sort of piling up on top of the elevator until it stops.
Does it seem like nice rope, or is it just like real crappy rope?
It's a good thick cable type rope.
All right, I'm gonna gather the rope up and then say, "You humans like to use this, right?" And then hand it to.
It's actually it didn't break. It's like the length of rope that spooled out on top and inside the elevator was the remainder that would have been if you had landed flush on the floor.
Oh, okay.
You're on top of a bunch of rubble.
Okay, I thought it all came down. All right, never mind then.
And this is what you see here. Just
slide.
Y'all motherfuckers like that.
I get off it.
Yeah, they like that rope.
I guess we get off the elevator then, guys.
More rocks.
Yes, the elevator came down on top of this. It's like the shaft was collapsed underneath it.
Okay, so it's not a trap or anything like that.
I don't know, is it?
Okay. Well, we came down on it.
Yes, the elevator came down on top of it.
Okay. Okay, no crunch. Wee, that was fun.
I can't reach the lever anymore with Mage Hand, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you tried.
Yeah, you estimated you probably went down a good 120 feet.
Really good. Doing some, lunking. Alright, so I guess we should fan out and in the immediate area. And start to look with our eyes.
Okay, it is very dark down here. Do you have a torch lit?
I have the dark vision.
You do.
I have dark vision.
Your boy's blind. you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna toss one up.
Which is funny. I don't even have eyeballs. I have photosensory cells.
Photosensory.
Five Fingers is looking around, like touching the wall. Like,
I can't see it.
Can't see that damn thing.
Kind of healing rock.
One of my little pseudopods is gonna grasp Five Fingers' nubby hand because that's the one that's shaped the same as mine. And then I'm gonna
take my strong hand. Take a little strong hand. I should have come on tight. I don't know if you're there. I get scared.
All right, so yeah, you can baby me around.
Wonder if I can get good at metamorphing enough to be worn as a piece of armor. That'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, just like have me as like a sneak attack initiative, like right on you.
So Osmir steps out off the elevator and he's looking around. He says, "It looks surprisingly clean down here."
Ah, yes, less rubble. I would like to do a survival check and look around if I see any foot traffic or evidence of foot traffic.
Okay.
That is a 19 plus.
The floor. The floor looks surprisingly well clean.
Is there like look like anybody passes through here or just like somebody brushed everything away?
And it looks like it has been kind of scrubbed.
Guys, I think we found the Mafia's ground. the Crimson shit. Blades.
Oh, how do you know that?
Well, they're the only guys that have stood up and... they're the ones that do all the robbery and banditry and kidnapping and... I don't know. Well, we're in the same area.
Yeah, but it could be any faction.
That's true, but I only know of the one, so this is my only education.
It could be a giant snake, as Robin would say.
I'm all ears if you have some extra factions, but remember, you found me in a wine cast.
Faction. Be a faction of you and wine cast.
Oh no, my worst enemy. Wine barrels.
okay. So. I guess we should find out. But there's two ways, so let's not assume that we should just go up or this way, and I'm pointing with my nub.
I like north. I'm going to say north.
You like north?
Okay, let me catch up
north
here.
North sounds good.
Okay, you want to move north, okay? Okay, so. Okay, that is what you see. There is a little pile of rocks right around here, but compared to what you've seen upstairs, it doesn't appear to be much.
Okay. I would like to move up to where the bend is, so I can see down the hallway. If I get out of the length of the torchlight, my dark vision will kick in for 60 feet, but I also roll a stealth check to try and... I don't know if something's there.
Can I just double check and see?
6, so 19.
Okay, you still don't see anything unusual. Like I said, the floor does look smooth, clean. Okay. Which for mine is unusual. And would you say, Red?
I was gonna say, can I check for traps? But I guess as it's smooth, then I don't have to roll. With my innate senses.
From what you can see from the torchlight, you are also concerned that it seems too clean.
All right, I relay. It's very clean.
Alright,
shoot, maybe it's an arena. We're gonna have to deathmatch some people here.
Yeah, that sounds great to me. I love killing. It's all about hunting for
more souls.
I need more meat to dissolve. This works out good.
Alright,
you take the souls, I'll take the physical body. Perfect.
You don't even have a stomach.
It was much better when I was pretending that he did have one.
No, he's right. I don't have a stomach.
No. This whole thing is a stomach.
Exactly. It
would, like, slowly
start
spreading out. I am the stomach.
I am the stomach.
I am the hype.
That's my secret cap. I'm always the stomach.
Honestly, that is my superpower.
It's like,
I'm always
the big screen.
Always. I mean, like, I'll get him from behind, but which side's behind? Oh no. Alright, well, I guess keep going until
Alan Z, fastly to the right. I mean, up, or whatever.
This direction?
Yeah.
Yes.
The right one.
Chroma, give me a perception check.
Perception check incoming. Let's go with, we'll go with reds today. Oh, let's see. Hold on. I just realized it's not working. 14 plus 4, 18.
Something seems to be blocking the passageway ahead.
I throw out, like, several pseudopods and, like, in the shape of the wings and stop everyone and said there's something up ahead. And then as they kind of retract in, I point.
Wait, you said that, like, in your language? Or you,
yeah.
Or did you say it through, like, my
yes.
No, I
when he's talking about his multiple voices, I'm thinking of one of the Ringworld series of the puppeteers. They talk like three
like
different heads.
I think about the dude from Mortal Kombat that has so many souls in them.
I was thinking, think of like, I don't know if you guys watch a lot of anime, but like the ghosts from like Noragami, where they all like talk with like kids and old dude voices all at the same time.
Oh, I like that anime. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah,
unfortunately, that's probably one of the few animes I have watched, so...
It needs a new season too, but
it definitely
yes,
does.
Can I roll an investigation check to see what's blocking the way?
Yes, of course.
I would like to ready an action if it turns around and attacks him. I want to run with my full movement speed and hit it.
And I would like to become the shadow right now.
Come on, the shadow.
It is 40 feet.
I'm also just gonna.
I have 17.
Okay, rolling. I have a 11. Yeah.
Okay. So 11. So describe to me what you're doing.
Well, I have dark vision, so I'm like putting my hands up against it, trying to feel what it's made of.
You're touching it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Giant slug.
Okay, your hand sinks into the mass that's in front of you, and you are stuck. It is pulling you in.
Oh boy. I think he's being attacked. I would like to run over there and strike at it.
It might be. Oh, excuse me. Might be a jello pudding. So.
I am also a pudding, so this will be a pudding fight.
Okay.
Finally, a worthy opponent.
I take off the popcorn.
Our battle will be legendary.
It will be legendary.
Dawn on a Bill Cosby smile.
Okay, hang on just a second. Since he's being engulfed, so I need to find out how much damage this does.
Does it that fast?
Damn.
You're getting fucking digested. Boy.
We're gonna die.
That's what happens when you say, oh my beer, I wanna touch this thing.
I mean, he's supposed to be like Drax, so, I mean.
I'm trying to think of what I can do to.
Okay, yeah, I need to get some D6s here. I'm going to light it, so I'm not doing full damage, so, because you're not fully engulfed yet. 6 points of damage.
Okay, 6 hit points.
Yes, so your hit point total go down by 6 points. This is acid damage.
Oh no, booby. Booby.
You feel your skin and your clothing and is just being dissolved.
Okay.
It's very painful.
Can I cast Hellish Rebuke?
Rebuke?
How do you say it?
Yeah, that is a reaction, is it not?
Mm-hmm. When you take damage, yes.
Yes, okay.
Within 60 feet of you.
Okay. Yes, go ahead.
It's the second level. Yes.
I have
19.
It's definitely a hit.
Let me roll for damage. Oh, wait, that was damage, my bad. Yeah, 19 and 19. Didn't matter anyways.
Okay.
Can I, like, just say something real quick? Since he is being captured right now, and sucked in, can I do a sleight of hand? Just fucking steal him away.
Can you do what?
a sleight of hand and steal him back? The fucking jello.
Let's see here.
I have the strongest sight of hand I've ever seen.
Right?
Yeah, one of them too.
Well, there is a way for someone to try to help extract him. It doesn't involve stealing, though. Let's see.
How big is the thing, anyway?
It fills the entire passageway in front of you. Okay,
what
yeah, you
my
would,
attack
you,
do, by the way?
You would need to do a strength check to try to pull him out.
Okay. Then yeah, not good.
Okay.
What would we have to roll to try to pull him out?
You would need to have a successful DC 12 strength check.
Okay.
12 or higher.
DC 12. Okay, I'm gonna try that because I have a really high strength counter, so I can probably roll that.
What did my attack do to it though?
Devilish reboot. You damaged it. There was a big splatter of ooze, gel, whatever it looks like, and it just sort of collapsed back in itself. It does appear to be lessened, but not by much.
Alright, so I'm going to roll a strength counter to see if I can pull him out.
Okay.
And would I be able to,
rolled
like,
11 assist? Plus 5, so 16.
Yes, you're successful. You have extracted him from this wall of gel.
Remind me not to touch anything down here.
I respond to him, the next time you touch something like that, I'll just cut your arms off.
That means don't touch me, I guess.
The mass is moving towards you guys.
Is it moving towards us?
Yes.
Alright, I want to attack it.
Okay.
Before we start this, I want to let you know that I have resistance against poison and acid damage. So if you do damage me, it's half. But I am going to just wail into it.
Okay.
Okay. So, here we go. Gel on gel warfare. Alright, so the first one is going to be a... 11.
Okay. Let's see. Armor class 6, yes, you hit him.
Okay. So yep. That is a 4 plus 2, so 6 Oop. Damage. Followed by a bonus attack. Oh, off the table, doesn't count. Different roll. That one is a 3 plus 6, so 9. And then that's, again, 2 plus 4, so 6. And then I'm going to...
Hang on a second. I sort of lost stuff here. Okay. So that, minus 9. Okay.
Okay. And then for your blows, key point it. That is a crit.
Okay, that's double damage.
Okay, so how do you want me to do it? You want me to roll 2 damage dice, or you just want me to roll once and then you double it?
Roll once and double it.
Okay. So roll, that's a 2 again. Man, lots of 2s. 2 plus 4, so 6, so 12.
12, okay. Alrighty. Now there's shit flying everywhere. The mass is definitely reducing. It is still alive. Oh, by the way, since our last session, you guys took a short rest. So, if you were missing something that needed to be short rest to recover, you've done so. Like your breath weapon.
That's good. I needed that, actually.
Did you catch that, Kyle? You're muted, Kyle.
Yes, I did. I did catch that.
Okay.
Sorry, I was talking. I thought you responded, but I forgot I was on mute. Because you said my breath weapon, and I was like, yes, I will definitely need to use that so we can dissolve this thing. And then you were like, Kyle, hello.
I'm gonna hit this thing with Scorching Ray.
Okay.
Ooh.
So.
It's a good old Scorching Ray.
That's the 19 to hit.
It's a hit.
And that's 10 damage.
Okay, you vaporized a good portion of the mass, and it is still approaching though.
All right, I'm gonna hit it with breath weapon. I have a 30-foot range on it.
Okay.
Rolled a damage of 9.
All right, you vaporized a good chunk of it. It does seem to be extremely hurt now. It is much reduced.
Fuck this jello monster.
Let's see. Has everyone had a chance to attack?
I have. I'm good.
Five fingers.
You're muted?
Hold on, be right back.
My bad. Yeah, I haven't gone yet.
Okay.
Oh, dear God. I guess I can only just, like, swipe at it.
Light?
Yeah, because I only have, like, flashing. Alright, so I'm still sneaking, right?
Yes.
Not really do much, but... piercing. Oh, this is gonna do shit. Fuck it, let's try.
By the way, you still carrying the torch?
I am.
Or it's okay, well, you're having a difficult being sneaky, but that's okay.
Oh, hold on, is this my last torch? Okay, so no sneaking then. So then I'm everybody spill your pockets. And I'm gonna ask if anybody has any like oil on them.
Do you want a pebble?
Oil.
I have no oil.
Yeah, I have oil.
Petroleum, gasoline, kerosene, something.
All right, fuck it. I'm gonna take my bedroll. I'm gonna lay it out in the path, and I'm gonna light that shit up on fire with a fucking torch.
You're just putting it on the floor of the cave, or what?
Yeah, putting it on the floor of the cave in its path, so it makes a big like ball of fire.
Okay.
Bold strategy, Cotton. We'll see if it pays off for him.
That's all I got. I mean, I'm not gonna fuck up the pincushion.
Okay. The creature reacts to the fire, moves away, but it still moves towards somebody. And if everybody else is attacked,
yeah, meeny,
meeny, miny, mo. So that's Space Cowboy. What's your armor class, Space Cowboy?
Where would I check that?
Be on your sheet. Should AC. Be towards the top of the AC.
11.
Okay. Alrighty, that's what does that damage cost? Okay, you take 7 points from a pseudopod as it strikes your body of acid damage. If you have a resistance to acid damage, take half.
Okay. Damn, you would die, dude. Then what, your second hit?
And the cube moves closer.
No ideas. Y'all got like some shit to do.
Yeah, everybody can attack again should you want to.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll try attacking with my regular attack.
Okay.
Sword. Nope. That's an 8.
You rolled an 8? Its armor class is 6, so you probably hit it.
Oh, okay. Cool.
What's your damage?
8.
It is collapsing. It's not done yet, but it is severely reduced.
Do I get another attack?
He's mine.
No, he's mine.
Fine.
Don't I get 2 attacks?
Does your character she say so?
Where would it say that? Oh, attacks for Ashton 1. That's okay, so that's only 1 attack then. Okay, no. That's good enough.
Next.
Alright. I'm going to take a swing with my lawn sword.
Okay.
Alright, decapitate this SOB.
Oh my gosh, we're decapitating?
I'm going for.
Man, what did I miss?
So I'm going to carve this turvy. What'd you say?
11.
That's a hit.
Hope I'm not getting decapitated.
Roll your damage. All
right. Roll for damage. 6 plus 5, 11.
You took a massive chunk out of it, and with a shudder, it just turns into a puddle on the floor.
Anybody got heels?
After a little wisp of
We're
smoke,
not eating that.
It starts to dissolve. Congratulations, you guys just defeated a gelatinous cube. I haven't used one of those in ages.
I know you got the inspiration. You solved your gelatinous cube.
I know as soon as I touched it, I was like, it's either a giant fucking snake or some slime creature. And then it stuck me in. I was like, it's the slime creature.
And now you know why the cave floor is so clean.
I didn't pick that up.
Who knew mines had their own personal Uber or Hoover vacuum?
Okay, I'm going to refresh my drink. I'll be right back. Next, I can still hear you though. So discuss amongst yourselves.
Well, I just noticed.
You remember that time when you fucking killed that gelatinous cube?
Yeah. I just noticed I have a pretty good medicine skill, but I have nothing for medicine.
Well, that's unfortunate.
So you could also use it just to do like sutures and stitches or first aid, resetting bones, things like that.
Yeah.
Oh, we killed a squishy.
Should have absorbed him. I could have got bigger.
You could probably still suck up the water.
I'll try. We'll see what he says.
He falls into the cracks.
If I try to drink this, Morgan, what's going to happen?
You're not getting much nutrients from it, but you recognize a cousin.
Damn. Did he have anything floating inside of him of value?
No, that's why you couldn't exactly tell what it was. It was pretty transparent.
Oh, well.
What was his name?
Roomba.
Roomba. Yeah.
Oh, that's got to be like a little Roomba. Just a little Roomba.
Don't worry, I feel no emotion for him.
Meanwhile, Zorbon's just standing there, his like arm like partly decayed. He's like, I'm fine, it's good. Everything's great.
Walk over and I prod it and I'm like, does that feel? Is that tender?
What are nerve endings? I don't even have them anymore.
I don't have to shave that arm tonight.
Shave it.
We have fun though.
No, but seriously, does anybody have heals?
I'll try to sterilize the wound so it doesn't do further damage.
Okay, do you get like a medic kit or something? First aid kit?
I have nothing.
I'll roll a medicine check. I would like to use my gelatinous self to pull off all the debris and everything that I can based off this medicine check.
Okay.
Hey, you get a witchy turn. I'm already doing that.
So as I extend forward and attempt, I get an 8, so it did not go very well.
Your teammate just sort of rubs a pseudopod over your body, and you're wondering what he's trying to do.
I get rocks mostly.
Why is it slimy?
Hey, well, don't worry. My immune system will kill the bacteria at the very least.
I'll just chill in the back. You guys can move forward.
No. We got more of this. Come on. Let's hunker down. It's been a while doing this.
I'll try again if you want, but if I roll worse, I don't know.
It's okay. It's okay.
I'll do it myself. I'm gonna rip my shirt and I'm gonna do a medicine check for putting my arm in the sling using the ripped cloth.
Okay.
You're gonna get worse. You're gonna get infected.
Go ahead and give me a medicine check, bro.
It's a 4. It doesn't even work. It just the cloth rips and my arm falls down and it just hurts.
You're having a bit difficulty tying on a sling with one hand. So. Anybody else want to assist him?
I'll try again if you'll let me. I'll try again. We'll go black this time. Man, the gods must really not want you to get your arm fixed. That's a 10. I got 2 extra points.
You get a 10? Okay, well, you sort of helped him a little bit. Your skin's no longer burning. And you can use the arm. It's just really damaged.
All right.
So do you get like 1 health point back?
I'll extort somebody into healing you.
All right. Onwards.
So I point out as we're leaving, hey, didn't the old guy also have a really messed up arm?
Oh, shit. That's you from the future.
No, it's not. Shut the fuck up. I am not some old human.
You wouldn't forget about yourself, but you had to try to help yourself out.
It was me, Barry.
He's not even a tiefling.
It was me all along.
It was me all along.
I can hear you. I'm gonna get a snack.
All right. So, where were we up in this then?
Last I heard was that we're moving on. So.
Yes, Alonzi.
So I got us right around here. Gelatinous cube is right there, what's left of it. And further down the clean passageway, like I said, now you know why it's clean.
All right. Is it getting any brighter or anything down
there? No, it's still, you're still on the ground. It's still dark.
Huh. There's some Ultima stuff right here. Okay. I will try to scout out a little bit ahead.
Okay.
With my torch, though. But I'm gonna like hold my dagger in my mouth, and at the ready.
Okay, I got you.
Like clenching my teeth.
I mean, I could walk next to you, and you can just stick it in me if you want.
Or I could just turn you invisible. There's that. Like, just make you invisible.
No, I'm good. We'll save that for a rainy day.
You know, I would like to roll a stealth check to hide from Five Fingers and just follow her behind her without her noticing I'm there.
You're going to be sort of like a shadow puddle?
Yeah. That way when she stops and looks back to tell us something, she'll be like, oh, shit. That's what I'm hoping for.
Okay.
It didn't work. I got to roll a 4 plus 6. Oh.
I'm going to roll a stealth check for the same thing, too, so I'll just follow behind. I'm gonna follow behind fucking Chroma.
Oh my god, we turned into Scooby Doo.
Yeah, these two fools are just like creeping up behind that. I was like,
It was a failure anyway, so it was like a 5.
Five fingers when you turn around, you must go zoinks.
Zoinks, zoinks.
Come on, guys.
Okay, you're coming upon a bend in the tunnel. I can expand it a little bit for you guys.
I would like to look around. Do anything that called my attention.
It's still extremely clean here. There are occasional you know, rock movement sounds, but other than that, it's eerily quiet.
Can I look up?
Yeah.
And see.
Hello.
Is there anything up there? It also looks relatively smooth. Remember, the gelatinous cube filled the space that it was in, so it can expand or contract as needed.
I'm not.
I'm sorry?
I'm just gonna clap hands and see if Zorban's just gonna clap his hands to see if there's anything respond.
Oh, okay. Well, you clap your hands. There's echo from the surrounding walls, but nothing else.
Let's see if I have anything that I can do. I don't really have much. I'm just a big dead.
Maybe we should go back the way.
We're at a dead end then, huh?
No, not a dead end yet. It does continue.
All right, continue and investigate. I put my monocle on.
You're coming upon a Y.
A fork.
Fork. Why?
A fork.
Oh, let's split up.
It's a fork and Y.
That's a fork and Y.
So which way?
Let's keep going and proceed forward.
Go up?
Yeah, left side.
Okay, there is a massive pile of rocks here. However, you do see some shapes up in the top. For dark vision people, they're obscurely gray. Torchlight doesn't quite make it there, so you're able to see further.
Firebolt at it.
But you can't quite tell what it is from here. It is not moving.
You want me to hit it with a firebolt, guys?
I'm not touching it.
I mean, I can also assassinate something, so let me just become the darkness.
What are you doing with the torch?
I just place it down where I think that. Hold on.
I'll grab it. I'm holding it with my tail.
You got it. I'm at your mercy.
I'm also going to extend it up as high as I possibly can.
Okay.
Which, according to my pseudopod, is what is that? Amorphous? No. Shapes elf. 10 feet higher.
Okay, so you're scraping the ceiling.
There you go. It's up at the ceiling.
So, Five Fingers, what would you like to do?
I would like to, if I could still see, and it's like some ambient light, that'd be great.
Yes, there's enough light being projected that you can make out the shapes. Roughly in the center here.
Don't fall.
So what are the shapes like then?
Roughly man-looking from like the waist up.
Okay.
He does seem kind of slumped a little bit. Like he's grasping something in front of him. His back is to you.
Okay.
At least then, you think it's a man.
I will, Alright, so I rolled a, 22 for my stealth.
Okay. Oh, you're very stealthy.
Selfie boy, girl.
I'm practically stealing.
So I'm gonna go just walk up and I'm gonna carefully take a look and circle around him in the shadows. If there's enough shadows, too.
Yeah.
Sweet. Alright, and do I see the front of him now? Is he like, is he dead?
Yeah, you see in the sides, the profile of this person, the sunken.
Okay.
The cheeks of dried flesh are sunken to the skull. It's definitely got a death mask on. It seems to be gripping a sword, which is plunged down into the rock pile in front of it. It looks like it's the only thing that's holding the body up.
I here.
Be wary of curses.
Be wary of collapsing as well.
Yeah, that's right. This is a small fire in your
Don't you dare. Don't you get
move one leg open.
Disarm. Alright, I'm going to go and I'm going to double check for traps. So, would that be a was it investigation perception?
Investigation.
Oh, crit. I crit one.
Oh, you just looks like an ordinary pile of rocks to you.
Oh, thank
you. Well, there we go. All right. Well, he's got a sword, though. Eh.
Looks like a very ornate sword from here, too.
Yeah, he looks pretty dead, too.
Sword of stone.
Okay, well, I gotta have it.
Does he become king if he pulls the sword out?
Only king of the zombies.
I'm not an innately evil person, so I can't, like, just ready and attack him. But, I'm going to...
Oh, as far as you could tell, Five Fingers, this is a very dead person.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure. Okay. Alright, cool. So then I'm going to try to, like... I'm going to use my sleight of hand, but I think that's... Yeah, just try to, like, very cunningly, like... Stealthily, just, like... Take it out.
Okay, so you get up to the body. Its hands are grasped around the hilt.
Mm-hmm.
You can see ornate carvings on the blade itself. At least as far as the blade that you can see. It looks like it's buried about halfway into the rocks.
Would I know anything about, like, anything... Let's see.
What languages can you read?
Arcane. Dwarvish? Common and Thieves' Cant.
Nope, none of those.
I'll yell at the Five Fingers and be like, whatever you find, if you can't read it, I'll bet you I can.
Okay. Well, I don't know if I didn't, like, hit any traps or anything like that, so... So can I explain to him the words, like, describe the
shapes? You can try.
What would that be?
Let's see.
You could just give him a raw ability stick. So intelligence or wisdom.
That sounds like a good thing. Intelligence. Yeah. Give me intelligence roll.
I need that.
Just like that.
Oh shit. 21. That's a nat 20.
You have no problems describing the inscription, what the symbols look like.
I have the eyes of the rune keeper.
You have to actually see the runes to do that.
But I did it so well, though.
It does sound familiar to you, though.
Languages I know should be... I know Abyssal, Celestial, Common, and Infernal.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like any of those. They're too elegant.
I don't know.
Is that a history check or just intelligence? I'll give it a shot too.
Yeah, you want to try history? Sure.
Oh shit! I hit intelligence. Fuck. I'll do that. 12.
You've definitely seen the script-like runes before. You just can't remember where.
Screw it. I'm gonna use my thieves' tools, and I'm sure there's, like, that I can use, like, flyers and, like, fly it out, like, so that I don't have to, like, touch it.
Touch the sword or touch the body?
That icky body.
So you want to try
the icky body.
So you want to try to pry the, pry his skeletal mummified hands off the blade hilt?
Yeah, they look pretty, like, right on there.
Yeah, it's like he's just ripped it like this.
I hear a sound of Cheetos cracking for some reason.
I'm just from the the base. I'm still holding the torch. I say, hurry it up.
All right, I grab it. I go for the sword.
Okay. As you pull the sword from the rocks, you can see that the blade just that's exposed is very, very clean looking. However, the ground underneath you shifts madly. Dexterity saving throw -5, please.
Oh shit!
I told you.
Dex. So it's gonna be normal.
Oh no.
13 -5. That's
eight.
I got something I want to do.
Did you say eight?
Eight.
Okay, the ground, this whole entire area here just suddenly just disappears out from underneath you. You with a scream, you start plunging into darkness. You still have the blade, though. Reactions from anybody else?
Yeah, I would like to spend a key point to do Step of the Wind to double my movement speed, which would be 80, and then I'm going to try and catch him.
Try to grab him? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm her.
Do your thing, man.
All right, so with my 80 feet of movement speed, I could get there very quickly.
Yep.
So that's my bonus action gone. But I'm going to reach out and try to grab him. No. So with just added dexterity to that. You want ability or saving throw?
Probably ability, since I might be able to.
No, I'm talking to the DM. I don't think it's gonna matter. Unless if it gives me advantage.
Well, I'm gonna since you've doubled your movement, I'm gonna give you a second attempt. So yeah, consider it advantage.
All right. I can't make this up, Morgan. Two 2s.
I'm glad.
2s. Five fingers as you're plummeting down into the darkness, which seems to be glowing with the bluish light down below. You feel it's pseudopods so just whipped by your body, missing you with scant inches.
I tried my darnest.
I look at the dragon. I'm like, you can fly, right?
No,
I have acrobatics.
I can fall with style. That's fun. All I can do.
You can see a rough surface approaching from below you as you're mixed in with the rubble that's cascading down from the from above.
Hold on. Can I acrobat? Like, can I just like? Can I do like just dive like to the wall and then like kick myself off and do a barrel roll?
You can certainly try.
Oh man, that's a steep set of rules right there. Good luck.
I mean, I got nothing else. I mean, to be honest, I have a crowbar, but I have a sword in my hand right now.
Well, according to Eminence and Shadow, crowbar's the best.
Oh, who's the guy in Half Life?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, okay, well, all right, let's go with that then. Can I just like fucking put the sword in my like sheath the sword and then grab my crowbar and go pop?
Do you have a sheath for it?
No.
Or are you trying to shove it into your belt?
I'm shoving it into his ass.
Just the belt. Just the belt.
Okay, give me a
if you didn't let go of the sword by now, you fucked up.
No, I got this.
give me a dexterity. For trying to sheath
the
brain.
Like a dragon in a tiefling, looking down at them falling, being like, huh, maybe we should do something.
17, okay, you shove it into your belt, and suddenly your belt just gets cut in half.
Ooh, sharpness, I like it.
There is a sound like snicker snack.
Well, I guess I go off and see that.
The floor is roughly is approaching rapidly.
I look back to you guys and I'm just like, missed him by that much.
All right, so I cut the belt, right?
Okay, we're going to call you Maxwell going forward.
You're saying I cut my belt. Can I just take it? Can't do it that way either.
One hand.
I'm playing one-handed character. Did I at least get the crowbar, though?
I need to beam it at this point. He realized he fucked up.
I will just try to see if I can tuck and roll as best as I can. Fucking the kick off the wall and tuck and roll.
Okay, so acrobatics or yeah,
core mechanics. Every 10 feet to D6.
So far you've fallen 20 feet. So we've nope, definitely slow motioned everything. So
yeah, I'm pretty dead. It's been real, guys. Bye.
Could I cast Earthbind and catch her?
Yeah, I think, right?
Yeah, hang on, let me review Earthbind. I've never used it before.
I love it, just like, you're just waiting all the way till the fucking pivotal. it's the dramatic timing, I get it. yell it back up. Oh, I'm gonna break something.
I've been falling for 30 minutes!
How long have we been falling? I don't know. My watch doesn't tell time. The Spy Kids 2 reference. Just so I can,
yeah.
Just so I can age myself.
Well, she had a good tapestry of the skills.
Allow it.
You'll allow it.
I'll allow it.
Alright. What would I do to cast that? It's a control effect, so...
Basically, from the way I'm reading it, you can control the ground to grasp or throw somebody. So I think if you can do that, you can also use it to catch.
Okay. So, it doesn't give me anything to roll.
You don't have to. It's a point. Five Fingers would make a strength check to oppose it, but since if he opposes it, he's gonna get fucked up, so he's probably not gonna oppose it.
So anyways, like this tree, these vines, black vines, are gonna shoot up out of the ground and like grab Five Fingers before she like reaches, like just impacts and hold her up in the air and slowly lower her down.
That just saved
me from splat.
It's gonna say it sounds like a good description to me as any. So yes,
I'm crying the entire time. I'm just blubbering.
Okay, you are lowered down to the floor of the area. The surrounding walls are glowing slightly blue, so you can see. You're in a very wide chamber.
I am not seeing.
I would like to acrobatics down there, via the side of the wall. That is a where is it? Acrobatics. 14.
Okay, not a problem. You make it down there with no damage.
Yeah. I'm just gonna use Earthbind to go down. See ya.
Okay.
You're spending them fucking spots. Yeah, you said you're a warlock, right?
Yep. So the warlock makes it down there.
I look up. Do you need help?
This is my character right now.
Kyle, do you need assistance, or can you figure a way down?
I think I'm gonna athletics my way down.
Okay.
Oh yeah, brute force.
Go ahead and give me a roll, please. FX.
They can do it nice.
Dang. a base. So 20 plus 7 is a 27.
Shit, you have no problem getting down there.
Yeah.
I would like to spend 30 minutes in meditation, and that is to the party.
just gonna come up and pat Five Fingers on the head and be like, there, it happens to us all.
And they just walked down, and I fell. And I was about to go, like, crack my skull open. And they just fucking phased down here, and they're fine.
Okay.
Short rest.
Yeah. Osmir is sort of looking down from above, going, I think I need a little help, y'all. I can't remember what voice he's using, so I'm just making it on the fly.
I will help.
Okay, so after some trial and error, you figured out a way to get him down there. So everybody's on the same level. I do not have a map for this right now, but yes, you could take as long as the rest as you want here.
I'm good with just a short. I don't know if anybody else needs more than that. I mean,
yeah,
Warlock's
short rest
probably.
Worked.
Warlock's almost out of spells at this point. He just burned two earth vines.
Yeah. So, short rest.
Okay, during the short rest, the blue light sort of flickers as it throbs a little bit. It gains its intensity and then fades down a little bit. It seems to be coming more from the northern direction.
I would like to follow the pulsating light for pulsating.
Does my health reset from the rest too? By the way,
I'm sorry.
Hit die.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Automatically apply healing with dice result.
So you get to roll the hit die, so like for me it's a D8. I got 2 D8s and 1 D6.
So I just go to skills then and fucking, I don't know. Where would I do this?
It would be on your
I'm on the mobile
sheet.
App, so
where is that? Damn, it's been a while since I looked at one of these sheets.
Same.
Somewhere under it should tell you what your hit dice are.
It should tell me what?
It says somewhere on there it should be telling what your hit dice are.
It's usually near his health.
Yeah, I'm looking at that. I can see what his current is and what his max is, but I can't see anything that says, you know, it dies.
Also, so you get the same amount per level as your, so what is he? You're a warlock, right? So warlocks, let's see. Warlocks get a D8. And we're level 3, so he should have 3 d8s total.
Okay.
Alright, so I just roll 3 d8s?
Yep.
You spend them as you want. So you spend one, get your health, spend another, get your health, and then just...
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But you don't get those back until a full rest, so like a full 8 to 10 hours of sleep.
Oh, okay.
Long rest, I think you get your proficiencies worth. So for
I just got a 2, so three.
Yeah, you're gonna want to roll another one. Oh, plus your con modifier. So whatever your con modifier is, I think. Pretty
Constitution.
Sure. Let me look.
It's plus 0, so.
I see. Hold on, minus 6. Let me look. I'm gonna double check on that. Yeah, plus your con modifier.
Yeah, so it's just 2 then, from rolling the D8.
So you got a 2 on the D8 and you have a plus 0 to Constitution?
Yeah.
Cool.
But I don't get that health back till I do a long rest. Is what you're
saying.
Well,
no, you get the health back when you roll the dice, so you gain 2 HP just
now.
But okay. You don't get the dice that you're rolling back until after a full rest. You get all of them back after full rest. You'll get your proficiencies worth.
Sounds good. Thank you. It's been so long since I played D&D.
I am looking something up here.
Oh, good. And my...
can't believe that I add advantage. I rolled 2 2s. That shit's crazy. Seriously.
Or does it show me the amount of spells I can use in a roll or anything?
You mean your spell slots or how many you can learn?
Well, I already know what I can learn, but where does it show like spell slots? Like how many spells I can use like during
That's on your. What app are you using?
D&D Beyond.
So there's a spells page for that.
Yeah.
And then it should tell you your spell slots. Which, honestly, now that I'm thinking about it, I don't even know if you have 2 level 2 spell slots.
Oh, I've been reading this entire time. It's under Manage Spells, and it's at the top. You can drop down 2 different drop downs, and it shows you little boxes. And that's where
they
end up. Yeah,
so you used all of your spells. You just had the 2.
Yeah, but a light rest would be fine. I think you're a light rester anyway.
I don't know. I don't think he gets his spells back until after a long. But let me look.
Okay, I found what I was looking for. So.
Oh no, yeah.
Like
yeah,
I said,
so
I...
You get them back after short rests.
So I'm sorry, I don't have a map for this. I thought I had one, but no, I had to not make it. So. My bad. We're going to have to do theater of mind on this one.
I have 5 spells, 2 packs I can use, and then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You should know.
6 cantrips, whatever you call them.
Yeah, well, you can cantrip all you want. So, if you can't get those spell slots back, then
wait,
don't you have
so...
a weapon? And
how
like
do you,
cantrips.
What was your pact? Or your
patron? The fiend.
Okay.
Yeah, we haven't determined what fiend yet, so.
I just said the fiend.
The fiend. There's only one in his mind.
We'll have to work on that backstory.
Definitely. You guys ready to continue
I'm,
now?
I'm making a good... yeah, sure. I'm fucking sucking my thumb.
Oh, as you're rummaging around... In the remains of the body, you do come across a sheath for the sword.
How conveniently placed.
Well, he had to put it somewhere, so.
Alright, well, so what happened?
You found the sheath for that sword.
Oh, good.
It was in
well,
the remains
good.
Of the body that tumbled down into the thing with you.
See, it's okay. No, I'm not like that.
That dead, dead buddy is very, very, very dead now.
Well, I was almost dead too. I should. Yeah,
you're
I
like,
can't believe I didn't pick
you're
up
like
on that.
Half naked right now, by the way.
Well, that's I lost my pants because the belt came off.
Well, the plus side, that sheath is on a belt, so.
Okay. Well, I got one now.
So you can put your pants back on.
There
can
you
I
go, you got pants
belt?
Again.
Or, not the belt, can I inspect the fucking sword? Was it worth it?
Yeah, show me the fucking sword.
Alright, yeah, and I show, I like fucking hold it out like I'm like, this is what it was worth. And I'll
do
this.
Do I recognize the runes? I speak Undercommon and Draconic.
This is neither one of those.
Excellent.
I'm just gonna look at the sword and use Eyes of the Rune Keeper.
Is this a long sword or a short sword?
It is a bastard sword.
Oh, it's a big boy.
Yeah, it's sort of like a hand and a half sword. And the runes are Atlantia.
Well, what does it say?
So I had
It seems to be some inscription relating to a poem. You can recognize the word snickersnack.
Snickersnack. I'm going to do a history check on those words.
Oh, yeah. Look up Jabberwocky. Yeah, roll your roll.
History. I got 14.
14. You get the vague impression that it is something to do with sharpness. Could be Vorpal.
Okay. Relay the knowledge to everybody else.
I show vast uninterest in this.
That was die for, so I might as well use it, right?
Can you even wield it?
Who, me?
That's a good question. I will try.
No, but... five fingers, because they only have one hand, and normally you need two.
It's not a two-handed sword, it's a hand and a half.
Ah, hand and a half, okay.
Hmm. So yeah, I don't have those, so... I guess I'll just grab it on my back, unless anybody want it. I almost died for your loot. No? Don't want
it? Not interested in it.
I sure as fuck can't wield.
Okay, well, it's gonna go right in the back then, and it's good luck to me now. Because I almost died.
Bag.
No, it's I strapped it to like a thing around it.
I'm gonna roll investigation and look around to see if there's an exit in the room.
Okay.
We're in.
To the north seems to be the brightest, where the pulsating light is coming from.
Anybody else want to go now?
Oh yeah, I'm ready to go.
Yeah, let's go.
I'm putting the image of the blade in the chat.
Oh, damn. I wish I had another hand to use that. Hmm. Yeah, well. I guess I'll just have to sell it. Or...
Melt slap five fingers in the back of the head for saying to sell.
I would bargain for it. Bargain it away.
Maybe we shouldn't sell the sword that we found from a dead corpse that almost killed you.
And it's Atlantean. That's very rare. Just general knowledge.
All right.
As you're approaching the northern wall, you can see the edge of the wall. There appears to be an arch and possibly a door. Oh, and the room that you are in is no longer mine-like. It's more like it was constructed. Aside from the collapsed rubble from the ceiling.
Yeah, I think it would have done a little bit better at that.
If only the sword was a dagger, I would take it. Shame.
Sorry, maybe we'll come across somebody who can use it.
Maybe.
I already have a long sword, so...
Dioda.
But yeah.
I could do something with it, but I don't get that spell till level 9, so...
Why am I streaming that? Stream this. My bad.
Very well. I want to continue going forward now that we have taken a short rest and I'm ready to things again. you know, my 30,000 hits per second. Can I do a survival check to see if it looks like any... signs of life have been through here lately?
Sure.
Alright, we rolled a 15 plus a 6.
There
21.
Is signs of, like, old footprints and stuff, but it appears to be very old.
Very old.
Nothing
Can I
recent.
Ascertain, like, what species, maybe?
humanoid-looking?
Humanoid-looking?
Mm-hmm.
Does it look like our dragonborn's foot?
No.
Damn. All right. I don't think they're too common.
Look like a man.
Since my dude, like, studies books and stuff like that, maybe I should do a... What would it be? Would it be... history? Try and, like, look at, like, the doorway and what it's made out of and try and determine what civilization constructed it. What would I roll for that?
Just investigation, yes.
I got a 15.
It's very fine stonework with some metal banding to, you know, on hinges and stuff like that onto the frame of the arch. It's an unusual construction. It's more something that you would find in a more regal place, and you would not expect it to be underground.
So this is a closed door, right?
It is a closed door, yes. It opens inward towards you. There's an iron ring on the door that you assume would pull to open it.
Does it look like airtight, or is there any crevices or anything?
There is gaps around where the seams are on the door.
Is it an inch or bigger?
Not on the sides or the top, but maybe on the bottom.
I would like to stick my head through and look at what's on the other side.
Okay.
Oh my god, I'm imagining that right now. Just like some fucking, like, E.T. looking, like, sludge, like, peeking out from under
okay.
the door.
As your head pod extrudes from the bottom of the door, you can see that you're in a long corridor that extends to your right and left. There are torches interspaced along the walls. The blue light is still there, but it fills the gaps between the torch light. So
okay, so the torches are lit.
The torches are lit. They give off normal light.
And it looks clean.
It's a very clean environment. There are two sets of boots, armored boots, on either side of you. With legs and body and...
And then I'm assuming they're not moving.
They're currently not moving, yes.
God, I hope those are armor stands and not people. Alright, so I'm going to slink back in and I'm going to say, somebody's home. Also, it's
I would have gone with knock knock personally, but...
Hey, I didn't go through. We can knock knock if you want. Let's do it. Knock knock.
Knock,
I'm just
knock.
A family dog.
You guys want to make an entrance? I think I have a cantrip that I could use to make quite a fucking entrance.
Yeah, do it.
I'm ready.
We already yelled at some stuff. Yeah.
Right.
Who's opening the door?
I'm just gonna slink back into the shadows.
I'll knock. Okay.
I'll kick the door open after you knock.
Okay, as I mentioned before, the door opens inward. See,
that's fine. Like, again, yeah, I knock.
Quit pushing
out. The boat flies and hits the door.
Okay, knock, knock. There is no reaction.
All right, I'm just gonna pull the door open.
I just walked.
Okay, you pull the door open. Strength check, please.
Let me make sure I don't get advantage on it because of my shit. I think that's only for grappling. But
the door pulls your arm off.
Okay, yeah, never mind. That's just for grappling, so regular. Woohoo! I didn't pull it hard enough. I actually pulled, and then it separated the slime from me, and I was like, dang.
The door did not budge.
It was with my face because I don't actually use my hand, so I bit it, and then my whole head came off, and I was like, oh. Nobody else do this. All right.
Who let the slime do the strength check?
I got this. Hold up.
I say that, by the way.
I rolled a 10.
Okay, you did not have the strength to open this door either.
I got a timeout. Oh, my
I'll do a strength check too.
Step aside. Let the dragon
go
through.
No.
After the lady started like fucking getting up, and you're like, step aside, ladies.
Yeah, we just let the freaking slime try to pull the door open.
Okay. Yeah.
Let's have the real man.
The real dragon digits. Man.
I take no offense to that. I am not a man.
Yeah, you could say he's gender fluid.
Oh man.
As my father would say, not that there's anything wrong with that.
I got a zero, so I just walked up to the door and like pulled on it with my pinky.
How do you get a zero?
Nat 1 minus 1.
That one minus one, exactly.
Okay. As a matter of fact, you fell on your ass, so.
Okay, now can I pull the door open?
Yes.
By all means.
Yes.
Okay, out of the way.
You got what?
I got a 25.
Okay, wrong. The door reaches open.
I'm amazed.
Okay, and you see the description that I mentioned before, the armored sets of armor turn to face you. Roll initiative.
I got 20.
Okay.
I got a 9.
Hang on, just a second.
I got something fun. I can't wait to try this.
The algorithm is perfect tonight for me. My fucking rolls. I got a fucking 1.
Okay.
I'm glad you're being sarcastic, because my rolls have only been working in combat. Everything utility-wise has just gone out the fucking window.
Chroma, what did you get?
9.
Red, you got what?
4. And fucking second time I've had like the lowest initiative.
Kyle, 7. You got what?
Oh, dear.
7.
20.
Kyle, you got 20?
No, I got a 7.
Yeah. 7, okay. Ooh, and I already got you, Cowboy. So.
Oh, I thought you were talking to me. Sorry.
I would have said Cowboy or Zalbarn, so. Okay, so.
I misheard, my bad.
2, 3, 4. Okay, got all that. And. There we go. I lost it. Damn it. Okay, it's a 5. Okay. Let me get their HP real quick.
I have something that I'm very eager to try, so I hope you're ready.
Oh no. Hope this better this goes better than letting the slime try and open a door.
You know, the funny thing is, I actually have a +1 to strength. This is a +1, but I rolled a 2 again. At least I'm not crit failing, I guess. That's the
okay. Zarbon, you are first in the initiative roll. What would you like to do?
Shit.
Shit's not an option. You can't take a shit right now.
Press Z. My arc hours seem to disagree with you.
So there's 2 on each, one on
there,
each
there's
side.
There's one on the left and one on the right. They're flanking the door.
Okay.
Let's see. Let's start.
And they are looking at us menacingly.
That's right.
They know shit make that sound?
Yes.
Would I be able to use...
That means the armor's not hollow.
Would I be able to use Earthbind to bind them both up and stop them from moving?
You can take one of them with it.
Alright, I'll just, you know what? I'll just hit the left one with Eldritch Blast.
Okay.
How about that? That's a 19 to hit.
Okay. That is actually a hit.
It's a 5 for damage.
Okay. Spong as your energy smacks into the body of armored suit. It sort of takes a step back. There's a noticeable dent in its breastplate. It reaches down and draws forth a sword. Slowly. It's not its turn yet, but that's what it looks like it's trying to do. Is there anything else you could do, Zorbon? Like, do you have multiple attack or anything like that?
Give me a second. Actions.
You got movement, actions, and bonus action.
It says I have a reaction. This says opportunity attack.
Yeah, not yet.
Not yet. Can I just, what would I have to roll to get out of the way and retreat?
You want to expend movement?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, just move. So which way direction are you moving?
I'm moving back.
Back? How far do you want to go?
40 feet.
Okay. So, does that end your turn?
Yep.
Okay. Chroma, you're up.
I got a 9. What?
What were you trying to do?
Okay. Wow. That is insane.
Well, most likely it's a miss, but...
No. I meant, like, that was my initiative roll.
Yeah, 9. Yeah, so
That's why I'm like, holy hell. Okay, well, dang, I was hoping somebody would be able to go up and get in its face so I could get advantage on rolls, but...
I'm too low on health, so there, buddy.
Said, hey, I give it my best shot. I'm back, you know.
Yeah.
Okay. Squishy.
All right, so I'll go to the one that was Eldritch Blast,
okay,
and I'll position myself to the left. So
it'd be the one on the left, left of the
door. I want me, enemy, empty space, enemy.
Okay.
Okay, and then I am going to hit him, do a tail swipe.
Here okay.
We go. That is a 13 plus 6, so a 19.
Good hit.
All right, and then here we come with the 2 plus 4, so a 6 damage.
Okay.
And then I'm going to bonus action hit again. That's another 13, so plus 6, 19. And then that's a 4 plus 4, an 8.
Mate.
Is it still standing?
It is still standing. You have put right. Serious dents in its breastplate.
All right, key point. Here we go. Roll again. that is a 16 plus 6, so a 22.
That's a hit.
And then a 2 plus 4, so 6 more damage.
Okay, you made a sizable dent in this breastplate. It is still standing.
Okay. That is all my turn.
Kyle, you're up.
All right, so let me see. I'm thinking. I obviously can't use a breath attack because I've already used that.
But you just had a short rest, so yes, you could.
Oh, I can't. Oh, yeah. Then I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna try to
vaporize him.
Which one? Shit.
I shouldn't be in the spot that I'm in then. If you could have got around and got
the,
a
the
you
know, the
I gotta,
what?
I gotta do what I gotta do.
Okay, the suit of armor on the left has already been engaged, but Chroma, the one on
you
the right,
what?
Not been damaged.
If you want to hit me, go ahead. I promise you I'll be fine. You can roll max
words.
Damage, and I'll be fine. Do it.
bold words, okay.
You want to try it? Do it.
You asked for it.
Poop around. Hit them both. Do it.
Alright, so damage roll for a breath weapon is 9.
The damage roll is 9. Okay, the suit of armor that both you and Chroma were attacking crumbles and falls apart. Badly
Wait,
beat up
go,
and
did you go? Did you go around so you could hit both?
Because
if you're just shooting me, you're screwing up.
I'm not just shooting you. No, I'm going around.
Okay. Oh.
Okay. So do we need to back up? So you expanded movement to go around Chroma and attack the armor from the backside, so you could get this the blast into the secondary armor. Is that what you intended to do? Okay, next time, make sure to verbalize that.
Specify.
Okay. Okay, so the first armor is down, the second armor. Clear this. Has been damaged, it is still standing.
Alright,
Let me update the initiative roll.
What's the list? Dex saving throw I gotta beat for you to take? Against your lightning. It should be written in your breath weapon.
He's talking to you, Kyle.
I'm sorry, what was the question?
What was the right. what's your dex saving throw for your breath weapon that I gotta beat to get half damage?
10.
10? Alright, yeah, so I got an 8 plus 6. So that beats it, and then I'm gonna spend a spell slot as a reaction to absorb elements. To further it even more, so instead of it goes from 9. Do you round up or down?
Down.
So then that's 4, and then 2. So I took 2 damage, and now you can see lightning coursing through my slime.
Looking quite pretty.
The little light show.
I'm gonna lighten the shit out of somebody the next turn. So thanks for that.
You want a pebble? Anybody want a pebble?
Okay. So the suit of armor, let's see. So Chroma would actually be the one person that is out in the hallway that it can attack. So what is your armor class, Chroma?
21.
Okay, let's see what the bonuses are.
How far?
Bring it. I don't have any more reactions, though. By the way, I used it to absorb some lightning.
Okay, so it's plus 4. You said 21?
21.
Alright, it missed. So it swung at you with the first time with an armored fist and missed, and second one. It's critical damage. How much damage does it do? That'd be 6 plus 2, so... Oh my god. 13 points of damage.
We're good.
Can I throw a pebble at him real quick?
No. You've already used your initiative round. Red, you're next. You're muted.
Forgot about the initiative.
How far am I away from?
Well, at last I heard everyone was sort of clustered around the doorway. Since you had typed it to open it, I assume you're still there. So you can see the right-handed armor. Just on the right-hand side of the doorway. Outside in the hallway.
Right-hand side. Okay. Well, I guess I'll make my way up. And since I don't have the element of sneak attack, I can still do a secondary attack.
You can still get your sneak damage because he's engaging me. And
yes, he's not paying attention to you at all. So I should
get it anyways if I'm within like 5 feet of somebody who I first attack.
Yeah,
that's why you
with
get
the second
it.
Attack. Yeah. Okay. All right, let's do that. I will attack with the short sword.
Oh, yeah.
No, I did it right here.
Okay, if you guys haven't caught on, critical damage or critical attacks do double damage, if I didn't mention it earlier. So if you get a 20, take your damage, double it.
First one's a 7.
7 damage or your attack?
7 attack.
It's a miss.
I didn't hear their AC.
Right. Their AC is 18.
Oh my god. Alright. And I'll follow it up with the another attack. 1.
Oh, bro. She's just not having a good day today.
No.
As you attempted to.
Hold on.
I need to make a critical failure table.
I should be able to disengage, I think.
Yes, but you've dropped your deck.
Retreat!
All right. Fucking hell.
Come back to Zorban. We'll protect you.
Just kill my character so I can roll my paladin that I made.
You've managed to disarm yourself. That's what you've done. Okay, so we're back to the top of the initiative. Cowboy, it is your turn.
Hey, Marty.
You were 20 feet back from the open doorway. You saw Five Fingers attack twice and dropped her dagger.
That was the fucking dice that rolled a 20 a minute ago.
I'm a take out a pebble and I'm gonna infuse it with magic and use the spell magic stone.
Ah,
and,
okay.
I'm gonna throw it. It has a range of 60 feet.
Okay.
So I'm gonna do the hit right now. That's a 18.
Ooh, that's a barely hit. You hit.
Fuck, 5 damage.
Hey, damage is damage.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else you'd like to do? You still got movement bonus action.
Bonus action. Let's see. No, I'll end my turn.
Okay, Chroma, you're up.
Alright, so the rogue is fighting him, correct? As well?
Actually, she has disengaged after she lost her dagger. So she's stepped back.
Alright, so it's just me.
With the dragonborn behind you, yes.
So he's not in fight.
Don't do what I did.
Damn it! Somebody get close to him! You're killing me! I'm a flanker! Oh! Alright. That's okay.
I dropped my daggy.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and attack. That's a 13 plus 6, 19.
It's a hit.
Again, yep, 19 to hit. This time though, when I strike him, with the dragon paw, I get an extra d6. It's lightning damage.
Okay.
That is a 5 plus 4 plus 4, so 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
13 points of damage?
13. 8 of it is from my fist, and then the 5 is from the lightning.
Okay. It's smoking, badly beat up, but it is still standing.
Okay, I'm gonna spend a key point and take the dodge action. So, as long as I can see the person, they make disadvantage attacks at me.
Noted, okay.
And I also want to provoke it by flaring my wings, my little jelly wings.
You come at me, bro.
Yeah, pretty much. That's gonna be a intimidation check of 12 plus... 3.
Yeah, it's a 15. Suit of armor, so it's not intimidating.
Hey, and I'm an animal.
Gladius, you're up. Gladius, the dragonborn is up. Can't hear you, bro.
Alright.
Thanks for that lightning, bro.
Yeah, no problem. I'm going to follow up by taking a whack at him with my longsword.
Okie dokie. Roll to attack.
Attack. Rolled an 18.
Oh, just hit. Roll your damage.
Rolled a 9.
Let me close this calculator here. The suit of armor busts into separate component pieces and collapses down to the floor. So, you're left with various bits of armor and two long swords.
Is there anything in the armor?
The armor, well, other than some smoke escaping from like the visor, there's nothing else. There's nothing corporeal.
Ah, so I could have done what I wanted to do. You said, ugh, so I was like, oh,
it made a noise, yes.
Nah, lame. All right, I'm gonna like snake into it and expand into the armor and wear it and look just like it and pretend this and like swing the longsword around for a few seconds and then just let go and go back to my dragon form.
Okay, you puppet it for a minute and then.
why am I getting like Sinbad vibes, the Disney movie where like she like makes a puppet and like just starts kind of flailing around with the puppet? That's kind of what I'm thinking of.
Yeah, a little better than Little Mermaid.
Well, okay, that's not a very high bar.
I'm at 12 health, so we should rest. At least a short rest. Then I get my key points back too.
But anybody else like to take a short rest?
Can I take one of the what did you say it was? Longsword or greatsword?
Longsword.
Longsword. Yeah, can I take one of those?
Sure.
All right. Zorban picks up a longsword and
They don't appear to be anything special. They're just long swords.
All right.
Is that like my sword too? That's not special.
Oh no, your sword is definitely does not look ordinary.
Okay. I'm like, I'll just put it back.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. So yeah, short rest.
Yes. Let me go get a refill of your.
I mean, you're the only reason I'm staying alive. All you guys.
I'm taking a rest.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Exactly. I'll get rid of them. Killing me. I'm never playing a rogue again. Like I have nothing. I'm so used to clerics with like a bunch of different utility spells.
All right, well, I'm out of hit die, and I'm at 24 out of my 27, so...
Okay. Well, let me know when you want me to step in, and I'll sacrifice myself for you.
So we're taking a short rest.
Yeah, took a short rest. Because I needed the key points back. I'll also out of spell slots for me, by the way.
Hey, yo!
It's your boy.
Alright. It's your boy. I'm really smart, but I'm as weak as a fucking slime.
Hey, you know what? I'm very tactical. I know how to hit people a lot, but I'm really tired today.
Yeah, no. I don't know. I don't know about that statement, man.
Probably
weaker than a slime. Come on, I, like, touched the door and it knocked me on my ass.
Yeah, no.
It took my head off, so.
No, it's the first I've ever had someone say just kill my character in the second roll.
Fucking hell, like, I just really, if I had a log of all of the rolls, like, it would just be pitiful. It'd be fucking pitiful. There has to be a log somewhere.
Oh, my goodness.
Game log.
Okay, so you've had your short rest. You've recovered your abilities that a short rest allows you to do.
Brilliant.
Yes, sir. All right. Last one to the bottom of the stairs is a rotten egg.
No, I'm good.
Wag my tail happily and use the full extent of my movement to get there.
Where are you going?
To the bottom of the stairs, apparently. I didn't even look.
What stairs?
The hallway. The hallway extends.
Hallway extends about 20 feet to the right and 30 feet to the left. Both make a, the one to the right makes a left turn. The one on the left makes a right turn. Both headed north.
I just rolled in my mind. I don't know why.
Test roll. That's wild.
Fucking whooped it. You just beefed it down the
stairs. Beefed it down the hallway.
Full tilt down the stairs.
What stairs? There's no stairs.
I fucked up, okay? I had stairs in my head for some reason.
Find some stairs and just fucking...
I'm just gonna make some stairs just to make you happy.
Alright, well, unless if somebody can go more than 80 feet a turn, I make it to the bottom of the fucking stairs.
What stairs? Yeah. Which way are you going? Right or left?
I'm going left. That's just left.
Okay.
In and left. I'm looking for stairs.
Mother. Okay, so you make it to the corner from the left-hand side, and what do you do now?
Stairs.
Find some stairs and fucking beat it there.
Hey, you peek around the corner, you do see a set of stairs going up.
Excellent. I make it to the bottom of the stairs.
Oh yeah.
And look back, and I'm like, made it.
Nice. I'm clapping against my nub.
I'm doing the thing when like your dog gets the zoomies, you know?
Oh god, so, you're not gonna do like Shadow, are you? And just go like, running into the sure entire
no,
the ground layer.
No, I'm stopped at the stairs. Okay,
the stairs do go up about 10 feet. There is torches at the top of the landing, and the walls do give off blue glow, which throbs, sort of fades in and fades out.
Should we go
up?
Robbing or should we go? Yeah.
Your options are to go up or go back the way you came.
Yeah, let's go up.
Yeah, we've come this far.
Sure. Why not? We found the stairs Orban was talking about somehow.
Yeah,
fucking. I'll have to map this out later. Make sure to add these stairs.
I was like, for some reason, I was picturing it, and my mind gave it stairs for some reason, and I was like, that big. I don't know.
Okay. As you make it up to the top of the stairs, you see a flicker of movement about 50 feet down the hallway. Everything's lit up pretty well from either the torches or the blue light.
You said it's a flickering what now?
A flicker of movement.
Flicker of movement. Firebolt.
Where it was?
Open my mouth. Yeah. Where it was.
Okay, so.
Just the whole slime just like
I'm already so defeated, so I'm not gonna go.
Hang on, just a second.
I'm picturing like this.
Opening my maw.
I did not expect you to do something like that, so hang on just a second.
Let me get max range for you.
Incinerates the whole fucking room.
Feet, so it could go for 120 feet till it hits something.
I wonder why you were gonna keep on sleeping. I'm not tired this time. You have to sleep somewhere.
The good
else.
News is we'll be able to see it coming towards us, and then we can run.
Okay. Armor class 12.
Oh, okay. I'll roll.
These are about starting to think
you
about
have, like,
bunking
a fucking infinite like down the range.
Oh wow, I rolled real good. 17 plus 5.
Oh hell yeah, he managed to hit it.
It's a D10. Hold on.
It'll be like the target range. Light, you gotta put a hostage somewhere.
1 point of damage.
Okay,
never
so...
Never in my life would I thought I see a slime more demonic than a tiefling.
There is a shriek, and it's the movement is no longer flickering. It definitely turns a shadowy gaze upon you. You have its attention. Roll for initiative, please.
I bow up a bit, like I'm, like proud.
I got 3.
Hey, you better did better than the shadow.
Oh no! It's too soon. He's dead. let's see. I got a 9 plus 4, so 13 this time. For Chroma, 13 Chroma.
13. I don't know. There's something terrifying about seeing a slime just opening up a gaping hole in its body and spitting out a fucking giant fireball.
Well, I'm in the shape of a dragon, so I did open my what appears to be the mouth.
Oh, okay.
Red, what'd you get for initiative?
18.
I'm sorry, say again.
18.
18. Oh boy. Kyle.
Yep.
What you got for initiative?
I have got 6.
Okay.
I ain't doing jack.
Well, like I said, you're better than the shadow, so.
I can't wait for the party to just all of a sudden one day just be like, you know what? Chroma, sick him. And then I'm just going
to. You're already doing it. We don't have to.
No. It'll be an NPC too. Like somebody will be talking shit to you, and you'll be like, let the dragon dog.
We'll just. We turn Chroma into a giant dragon wolf.
Sicky boy!
Right on his back into battle. Go, hey, Chroma!
That's what I'm working on, man. I want it. I want to be able to fly.
I host Silver.
Okay. Initiative order is Red, Chroma, Kyle, Zorbon, and then the creature. Red, you're up. What would you like to do?
How far am I away from this thing?
This thing is about 30 feet away.
I'll go up
to give you a description. This thing is a shadowy figure. It looks kind of semi-transparent.
So my stabbies isn't going to do anything to it.
You're
right?
Not exactly sure what you can do to this.
I will try anyway, because I have no trinkets or nothing. Just have these swords and this nub. So, let's see here. Yeah, I'll hit it with a short sword.
Okay, so that's slashing damage, correct?
Yep.
Okay, your AC to hit is 12.
Yeah, I hit 12, yep.
Okay, your sword passes through this creature. Seemingly, no effect whatsoever.
Yep. Okay.
Is there anything else you'd like
then
to do?
I'll just get the fuck out of there. let let them take care of it. I have nothing.
Is there an evasion score?
I should be able to get away because I have two. What's it called?
Disengage?
I can dash, disengage, or hide.
Oh yeah, that might be a good thing to
do. I'll just hide.
You might want to disengage.
Make myself useful and hide. Or disengage, yeah.
Okay. So, back to initiative order. We now have Chroma. You are up.
Okay.
Just to drive home the point, you saw Five Fingers expertly wield his short sword, and it passed harmlessly through the creature.
Very well. Well, if that's the case... Like it passed through and it seemed like it did no damage at all?
Yep, just sort of whiffed like it was nothing. Remember, you had a short rest, everyone. Just
Well Well, that's weird, because my unarmed attacks aren't magical until level 6, so now I'm worried. Okay, cool. Magic it is.
Hmm?
Going to hit it with a acid splash.
Okay.
I don't have to move. It's a range of 60 feet. And it has to make a dex saving throw with 13.
Oh, hang on just a second. Red, what was your damage? Or did you get a chance to do damage?
I don't think it rolled it because you said it. Whizzed right through.
I apologize. It's a resistance. Roll your damage.
Oh, that changes my whole strategy.
Yeah, okay. I thought it might.
1d. On 6. Who's playing nice with me today? That's 5.
So that's 2.
Hold on. That's do extra damage 3. Then. Attacker. I probably would have.
3.
I'll just let the one attack it.
15.
I don't want to go too far back.
Minus 3.
So you, okay. did you still disengage since you dealt damage to it?
Yeah, you did.
I'll just look like I.
Yeah,
like
you did hurt it. It reacted to being hit, but you really didn't feel anything as your blade. You know, there was a slight tug, but nothing what you would normally expect.
Yeah, that makes sense. I probably would have just been like, yeah.
Okay, Chroma, what would you like to do now?
All right, so I am going to now know that since I can punch it, like I solve all of my problems. I'm going to attack it, and then as a bonus action, I'm probably going to miss that. A 9.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to whiff, and then bonus action... I should now be the closest person to it, right?
Yes. I assumed you moved forward to attack.
I did. Yeah, I'm in the 5 feet span. I'm gonna take the dodge action, so it's at disadvantage if it wants to hit me for the rest of the turn, till my turn.
So it ends your turn?
Yes, and that's it.
Claudius, it's your turn. Kyle. You might be muted. There you go.
Yeah. I am going to go, since I rested, go with the breath weapon, because I really don't have a whole lot of magic.
Okay.
Hey, man, at least you're a dragonborn who uses his breath weapon.
Yeah. Also, it is lightning-based, so...
Hey, I can't absorb this one, so don't fucking shoot me this time.
What he's going off of in the campaign, in his campaign, we're playing with, there is a dragonborn who never uses his breath weapon.
Never. Not a single damn time.
Is he even really a dragon, then?
Yeah, there's that, yeah.
He's supposed to be.
So, I'm going to attack him with the breath weapon. Let's roll for that.
And my music is popping right now. Holy shit.
What'd you say?
Oh, shit.
Music. I was like, my music is popping right now. Holy shit. And this is like, fuck, this is fight music.
Kyle, what does well shit translate to?
That's it translates to 5.
Oh. Unfortunately, that is a miss.
Miss breathing. All I had to do was breathe on the guy, and I missed. You even do that?
Your lightning sparked off into the walls, taking out chunks of shit, and knocked down a torch.
Turns out I wasn't really using my breath weapon, I was just sneezing.
His breath weapon's a dex save.
The other hole.
It's a dex save?
I'm gonna blast
well,
with dragon breath.
In the case of the dex save, you did manage to hit, so disregard that funny sound I just played. So roll your damage.
The damage is 12.
Oh, God almighty.
Well, don't worry. It could still take half.
Actually, I don't think it's resistant to that type of damage. Hang on a second.
Holy shit!
Okay, yes, it is resistant to that. So yeah, it's there. It's still there.
I don't want to meta, but just because of what you're telling
thank
me.
You, thank you, thank you, thank you.
I'm not going to, don't worry.
Yes, so the lightning strikes the creature. It shimmers and shakes, but and it is still there, but it is visibly damaged. Let's see. Next, anything else you'd like to do?
Convince it to hit me while you're at it. That's the best way
we
can do that.
I'll roll an intimidation.
Okay, go ahead.
Persuasion. Hey, fuck up the slime.
I rolled a 10 on intimidation.
It's good. We want you to be not a threat.
Yeah, I don't think that is a that is not successful.
I don't know. It's shadowy and demon, so maybe the tiefling can converse it. You know, I mean, like, sorry, our dog just gets out of control sometimes. You know,
okay.
Working on it.
Does that end your turn? I see you lighting up, but I'm not hearing anything. Does that end your turn?
Yes, that I place one face down and end my turn.
Trap card. Okay. Survive. You're up.
Play spell depends on what we're playing.
Who's up?
Zorbon, it is your turn.
Hell yeah, Zorbon.
I'm going to stare it down with purple glowing eyes, and I'm going to cast Eldritch Blast on it.
Okay.
I got a 11 to hit.
Oh. And, that is a, is an armor class hit you're trying to do, or is it something else?
What?
Hang yeah, on. Eldritch Blast is a ranged attack.
Yeah, okay. Unfortunately, that's
yeah,
a miss.
Yeah, it's a range.
That's a miss.
Damn.
You need a 12 or better.
Well, in my turn, then.
Okay, so now it is Shadow's turn. Closest target
Chroma.
Is either the plasmoid Chroma. Or the dragonborn.
You're not brave enough.
1 to 3,
Chroma
plasmoid.
Just, like, buffs up and...
4 to 6 dragonborn.
Roma just, like, puffs up into, like, a buff weightlifter and is like, you okay. Can't handle this!
Where the hell did my die go? Yeah, hang on, I gotta rewind. Hit the floor.
I am Shia LaPlasmoid.
Dragonborn is being attacked by the shadow.
Oh, come on. Wrong dragon. The one that's at least shaped accurately.
Okay, so what kind of attack do you do?
Oof.
Melee weapon attack.
You hit him with an oof.
Gladius, what's your AC?
The oof.
My AC?
Yes. Armor class.
Armor class 16.
Ooh, shit. It managed to hit you. It's a critical hit.
What?
2d6.
If only it would have went for me, he would have been at disadvantage, and we would have been Gucci. Gucci Goya Dry.
Okay. Alright, so 11, 22 points of damage. Strength drain.
Hey man, you good?
Or sorry, necrotic damage. 22 points of damage.
You folded like a lawn
chair? My hit points just went down to zero.
Okay, give me a
that's
death
an instant
save.
Kill, though.
No, it's not instant kill. It's death save. Roll a death save for me, please. Just roll a d20.
Now my room is really scared.
How do I roll a death save? Do I just click inspiration?
Just roll a d20.
Just a d20.
Okay, d20.
Oof. Well, I tried.
I rolled a 22.
Good. Okay, you survived the first one. You actually got one hit point of damage.
Gee.
Or I'm sorry, you recovered one hit point. You're
that's
not
what you're
dead.
Out that one for.
Basically, you're on the ground.
A damn near killed somebody.
Walk it off, frozen.
Walking off your dragon, right?
All right. We're back up to the top of the initiative. Red, you're up.
As a cleric, a previous cleric, I would probably do something about stabilizing him, but I'll go attack.
Well, he's already stabilized. He's at 1 HP.
Yeah.
Did I go off into the shadows, or did I just disengage, right?
You just sort of disengaged. You just sort of faded back a little bit and let other people sort of get up in his face, so you can attack again.
We need a gang rush this guy so I can be at advantage, okay? This
is like I ain't rushing shit, okay? Yeah,
there's a whole lot of, like, little attacks that I do all together, and I just have to remember which
ones
they are.
It's incorporeal. I can't grapple it, okay?
All right, so I'll just fucking not hit it.
A short sword again?
You could at least try it.
Okay.
It's incorporeal.
Right, let's see. That is a nat 20 plus 5.
Okay, roll your damage.
Yep. Oh, sorry, this is a d20 I'm rolling. I actually put my d6 away because I didn't get it ever do much anymore. That's a 6. So that's a max damage crit. So that's 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 points of damage. And then that would be double, right?
Yep. I'm looking for my sound effect.
Oh, shit. It's always going to be like, I'm going to roll shit, and then like, I'm going to
sacrifice
one dude. I swear to God, I can show you what I...
God damn it.
My dice are having fucking fun with me. It's not funny.
I can't find my sound effect.
This kind of makes me want to go back to playing a barbarian next time, because I've always had really good luck with barbarians.
Okay, the shadow vaporizes in front of your face. It just turns incorporeal. We are out of initiative. The danger is past.
I check on the dragonborn to see if he's alive or not.
He is alive, but just barely.
Alright, seeing that he is alive, I kind of just go away. I was going to eat him.
maybe we should.
It's like, as he approaches me, all I do is I look up at him and
get I'm like, oh, he's still breathing. I'll wait.
No lunch today.
You already have the shape of a dragonborn. Screw you.
No.
You don't need another one.
No, dragonborn. Dragon. Huge difference. I'll be a young dragonborn.
Oh my god.
Like, he approaches me and starts screaming, I do not consent! I do not consent!
Okay, now that the danger is past, where the shadow figure showed up before, there is a door up on the left-hand side of the passageway.
I do not run to the door.
Maybe we should take a long rest here, so that the dragonborn doesn't die, you know?
In a corridor?
I'm asking where the nearest hospital is.
I will go forward and check through the door. Maybe it's safer than the middle of a hallway.
Okay. Who's going to carry
the
dragon?
How macro works?
The dragonborn is able. The dragonborn is able to stand and walk, but just barely. Okay.
So you said the door is what, like 30 feet down the hallway?
Yeah, about 30 feet down the hall. It appears like the other door that you came through earlier. There is a gap down at the bottom.
I would like to attempt a stealth roll and then peek through to see what's on the other
side. Okay, do your stealth roll.
That is a 14 plus 6, so 20.
Okay, as your head emerges, you can see the room is lit up with torches, just like everywhere else. There is a table in the center of the room. It is a 20 by 20 room. There seems to be, you can almost say it's like a library, but there are also bottles up against one side of the wall, like on the northern wall.
Please, for the love of God, tell me it's medicine.
Zarbon would be like, does someone say books?
There are flasks and tubes and stuff along one side of the wall there.
Am I convinced that nothing's in there, or would you like
give an investigation roll?
Yeah, to just look around?
Yep,
or to...
yep.
Oh. You sure I can't do perception?
Do a perception if that's insight? Better. If you'd like to do perception, that's better.
Balls to the wall. I'm starting to fill them up.
Hey, look, man, I at least try to play to my strengths. It ain't much, man. I got a 9, so...
You do not detect any living soul within the room.
All right, cool. I'm gonna finish sliding under the door and open it in case it was locked.
Okay, so you managed to open the door easily, much easier than your first attempt on the other door.
No, thank God.
Yeah, well, it's better maintained.
All right, I beckon. I'm like, quick, in here.
I'm gonna walk in and see the bookshelves and investigate the bookshelves if there's any books on them. See if there's anything of. Like special.
Straight to the books.
Straight to the books.
I'm going straight to the whiskey to see if there's anything that's either going to heal me or at least let me forget that I'm.
Hold on. Are you incapacitated?
No, he's at one.
He's at one HP.
I got a 16 for investigation.
I will aid his investigation using a medicine check to see if it is.
Okay, there are several books here involving potions. And medicines, as far as the books go. There are also a few books regarding arcane texts.
I take the ones with the arcane text.
trying to come up with the word. Some necromancy textbooks.
No, I'm not interested in necromancy.
I take the necromancy books.
Okay. Along the wall with the potions and stuff, there appears to be several bottles of red liquid.
I'll just get the fucking red liquid. Here, grab it off the fucking wall, and I'll stabilize him. Just feed it. The red stuff.
I hope that's not poison.
Everybody is just like,
there is some text.
My eyes just widened, and I'm like, what are you doing?
Necromancy books. Here's a
shopping
potion.
Do you drink it or not?
There is some text on the bottles.
1 HP. Take this. Right. You'll be fine.
Hold on.
Just
let me.
Like minus 30 poison.
I'm going to roll a. I'll roll a passive perceiver. I'll roll
passive?
A perception.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. Roll your passive.
My passive is 14, so that's not bad.
See five figures standing over top of him while he's foaming at the mouth.
I rolled 13.
Okay, what languages can you read and write and speak?
Dwarf, the thieves one, and common.
Oh, well, common. It definitely says health potion.
No, thanks.
All right. Well, glad I glanced down for a second there.
little does he know it says not health potion.
Cook man.
And in some cases, it's if you're not dead.
Yeah. He just holds it up and says health potion. He turns it to the right a little bit.
You want it? And I'm holding it. I'm like bouncing it on my stomach.
Looks like there's about 3 doses in there.
Okay. Just take it. You lost all of your health.
Kyle, are you taking the potion?
Yes.
Okay. 9 hit points are recovered.
Yes. Can I take
medicine
the other one?
Is good.
There is another potion bottle there. Same thing.
I say we save it and just take a long rest.
Yeah, sure. Long rest, I'm good with that.
Okay, yep. Long rest it is.
It'll give me time. It'll give Zorbon time to look over the books during the long rest that he's found.
Okay, as you peruse in the books during your long rest, you can understand a little bit of the texts, but it's not really your forte.
Oh,
I'm sending you a DM, red shirt.
Okay. I'll be right back, guys. I'm gonna mute my mic.
Yeah. Off he goes.
Look at him. On the move.
Do I have a dog to see that?
Well, he didn't tell us that we took our last yet, so. Oh man.
I'm sorry. It's either fireworks or someone's shooting a gun outside.
I hope it's fireworks.
Welcome to Arizona.
I just gave you my MO.
Well, I know it's not me. I mean, where are you going to steal jelly?
No, I'm not going against anybody. I'm lawful.
I'm just playing against a rogue thing. I will tell you this, though. There are 16 gold pieces that kind of float around inside of my body here and there.
Ah! Okay. Maybe I'll.
I almost got those if you would have wrestled me.
I don't know about that, because you would have took them and then I would have went through your mouth.
Yeah, I don't think I want to piss you off. You've been saving me my ass too much.
Man, that was quick thinking there. I was like, wait. Maybe I can save her using the fucking earth magic.
That was a good call. That was like the textbook use of that spell. You're a wizard, Harry.
You're a wizard, Harry.
And I can act this out if you want me to.
All right, well, I don't know what he's doing, but if I find any books in Draconic, I want to read it. Or in anything for, like, elemental magic. That's all I care about.
I can't spell it, Rich, but that last word is undecipherable.
Okay, thank you.
All right. I'm an old boomer that can't spell that.
So these are just like, these are just random, right?
Yeah, basically random, yes.
Yeah, the best kind. Okay, cool.
Since I have eyes of the Runekeeper, wouldn't I be able to understand the books? Or
like I said, it is not your class of magic. So you get an inkling of what it's about, but you don't really grasp it. You can't grok it.
Okay.
However, they did appear to be spell text, possibly spell books. So a necromancer could definitely use them.
Oh yeah.
So, long rest, correct?
Correct.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Actually, it passes uneventfully. You're able to refresh yourself, regain hit points, and any other abilities that a long rest would give you.
I feel good now. I can go back and put people night-night.
We got a dancing dragon!
I would like to feel the neck break under my stomach.
Wow.
I have to keep those short because it actually cuts my mic off when I do it. So what would you like to do now?
I would also like to bring to attention that when we long rest, all right, and then Chroma takes a nap, I go from, like, I do, like, the circle thing that dogs do or cats do, and then right as I lay down and get comfortable, I slump into a puddle.
So you do the old circle, 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 and then...
I'm going to draw a comic of that, and it's going to be beautiful.
Oh, if you do, let me have it. I'll put it in the video.
Oh, hell yeah.
All right, so we're feeling refreshed, and we also have a free health potion. Let's give it to the Dragonborn since he was the closest to death.
He was already healed, wasn't he?
Yeah, no, I meant for, you know, in the future.
Oh, okay, yes.
You appear to be the tank of the group, is what he's saying.
Yeah.
Tank or meat shield?
Well, either way, meat shield or tank, I'm your best friend. Because you go in, I go in with you. Don't worry, I'll never leave you alone. We fight together, we die together. Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, well, if there's nothing else of value in this room that I can find, like I said, I wanted to look for anything elemental magic related or draconic, but if I didn't find anything cool.
There is a section that has been discovered that contains several scrolls. Five scrolls.
Five scrolls.
Alright, one for each of us.
Can I insight into those? Kind of get a little more details about it? Anything?
Since scrolls are pretty much can be used by anybody,
I can
arcana check if you want to try and figure
that out. That works really good. Let's do that.
Oof. All right. So I just want to let you guys know I'm not smart with magic. Everything's an 8. 10. I got
okay.
11 minus
one scroll is in enlarge.
Oh, that's me. Baby, let's go. Ooh, big so dragon.
Four left.
I'll just take one. You guys can have the rest.
Okay, so Red, you have the second one.
Yep.
Where you take? Where you want to check it out?
Yeah, sure. I'll read it. Do I have to magic it?
Arcana check, please.
Yep. 8.
Okay, this is polymorph self.
Okay.
Normally. I'll take the third one.
Okay.
Arcana check.
Yep.
18.
I'm sorry. Lightning bolt.
Lightning bolt?
Lightning bolt. Third, whatever the lightning bolt is. One more.
Come on, you know you want to roll there.
You're like flat.
You want to scroll, dragon.
Alright, rolling. Eleven.
Bixby's grasping hand, or Bixby's hand. There we go. Bixby's hand.
Oh my god, I have the perfect idea. Look, you guys can keep me in your bag, and then I'll just, you know, reach out and grab stuff from people like this.
All right, I'll take the last one, because that all went around in a circle.
Okay.
All right. Oh, yeah. That's a 20.
Fireball.
Fireball. Got it.
Nice.
These are single-use scrolls, so you scroll them out, you read them, the spell activates, scroll disappears, vaporizes.
I'm very excited to use this. I may even use it in the exact next fight.
Oh my god. Yes! Giant slime.
Somebody's getting a ride.
Yeah.
The Dragonborn firing lightning bolts off the top of me while I'm breathing fire.
Okay, I just envisioned Pete's dragon.
Just a gray and slimy.
Just tiefling, you know, up on top too, shooting like purple rays from its fingers.
The sending stones.
Yeah.
This is great. We're gonna have a good time.
Actually, that would be a dope. That would be a dope idea.
Chroma, I found this. I found this other potion over here. I think it's a healing potion, and I hand it over to you.
You can stick it in the slime like you do with that nice new fancy fridge that they got going around.
You got it. Right, and I hand you a potion.
I will extend a pseudopod out.
Yep. You now have this potion.
Excellent, I have the potion.
Is it one of the two that I didn't tell you what yep. it was? Okay.
All right, so I have no, you know what? I don't doubt you. And to be honest, if it's poison, I don't care about it.
You shouldn't, because I'm such a genuine person. You know, we've been friends all this time.
Let's make sure I know.
If you want me to drink it right now, I will.
No. Whatever you feel like.
I will kill you.
It might help out. I'm pretty sure all these seem pretty beneficial, don't they?
I wanted to make sure this was an actual thing.
Okay. And I am doing my deception on you. I'm your friend.
If you want me to counter deception, it's probably not going to go well for me because I rolled a 4. So, unless if he crit fails, I doubt he's going to lose.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a 22.
I'm ready. No matter. Wholeheartedly. I'm ready for whatever you guys want to do. So if you want to drink it, let me know.
I just what level
did cause... you say the scrolls were again?
I did not write this down.
You did enlarge. You did fireball. You did polymorph self. Those are the three that I heard.
Yeah, lightning.
Yeah, one was lightning. Yes.
Dash 4. So we're missing one.
Lightning bolt.
I'm just wondering what level the scrolls are. Are they like a level 2?
Level 3. I just replaced them, customized the level 3 scroll.
Yep.
Okay. You just override it.
Yeah, they're the base level of the spells of the same name.
So you just search up scroll.
Just search
spell the same name, and it's in scroll form, so you just read it out, anybody can use it, and the spell will activate. With a spell DC of 50.
A random potion, it's just, you were so happy about just getting me whatever, it's like, yeah. Is there something that might help out?
So, do you want to experiment with the potion, or would you like
yeah,
to?
Yeah, I will. I'll. Do I think it's magical in nature, or is it just like a chemical compound?
Oh no, it definitely appears to be magical in nature.
All right. I would prefer either medicine or insight, but I will roll Arcana if you tell me to.
Yeah, do Arcana.
Damn.
You're gonna die.
16.
Well, actually, that's a good roll. Stone skin.
Oh, damn. That's cool. Enlarge stone skin. I gotta look that up. Actually, it might not be beneficial for me, to be honest, because of how stone skin is, but I'll look it up to double check.
I can use stone skin.
Slip it in your pocket next time, or your body next
yeah,
time.
I was gonna say, what pockets are naked?
Put the link in the chat.
Oh, I got it, yeah. Oh, that's cool, yeah. I could use that. Better for a tank. I usually just duck and weave. Alright. I'm ready to roll out. If anybody else doesn't, I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm good.
Alright. Out the door.
Okay, to the right is the stairs that you came up. To the left, there is a 10-foot passage, and then it turns right.
Well,
let's go down the passage territory. And to the right.
Unexplored territory. Here we go.
Okay, so how are you approaching the corridor?
Do you want to take the lead on this one, Five Fingers, or do you want me to sneak around?
Slice the pie. We'll just slice the pie.
I can make one of you invisible to make it easier for sneaking if you want.
No, I'll go through.
I can pretend to be a box.
I'll become the shadow.
Okay, there are no shadows in this hallway. There's either torchlight or there's blue light.
I will become blue.
I'm blue, da 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 da.
If I was green, I would die.
All right, so then I'll just I'll just saunter out and take a little gander, and then if it looks all clear, then I'll continue up.
So you're peeking around the corner? Is that what I'm hearing?
Yeah, I'm gonna peek first.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna peek first with the with the metal, my thieves' tools, metal.
Okay, give me a stealth roll.
Activities. 11.
Okay. You do manage to peek around the corner. You see what you see and you rapidly pull back. Two sets of armor about 20 feet down the hallway. They are guarding the door to the north.
Always on.
Okay. I'm going to... I believe there should be some ball bearings in my sack.
Believe that is the case. Yes, I think you mentioned that before.
So you said it was pretty pristine floor.
Oh yeah, it's very clean here. It's not as clean as the gelatinous cube floor, but it's well maintained.
All right. So if I toss them down, they should go pretty far, all the way down there. You think?
I would say so. Yes.
All right. Then I'm gonna tuck them, kind of underhand fast throw. And see how far I can get.
Clatter down the passageway around the feet of the armored suits, and some of them proceed on the other side. You seem to have the hallway pretty covered with your ball bearings. The suits do not react.
And then I'll, can I do a stealth attack with my dagger throw?
I don't see why you couldn't.
Okay. So that's just a hit, right?
Yes.
Dagger.
Let me find my armor.
That is
animated suits of armor again. Hang on.
That's a 16, and also that. Yeah. I don't think there's anything else of it. It's a stealth attack, right? Like, you assassinate?
Yes, I'll give you that.
Maybe.
AC 18. Any bonuses to your assassinate? You can include those in your roll.
Yeah.
Sneak attack, all those bonuses.
Starting at third level, your deadliest weapon, you give the dropping enemy to the attack roll. Take an advantage attack roll, so I'd take the higher of two, right?
Yep.
So I'll get the hang of this eventually.
So will I.
It's tough. It's 15.
Hang on a second. That is a hit.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to... Kind of hard doing math when you're stoned or drinking.
Yeah, I usually have three calculators.
Yeah. Right. That's why I said stairs. I was like,
that's sneak attack damage.
Yes, it is sneak attack damage. Let's see. What is her HP? 3. Okay. So, 2 sets of armor.
All right, and that's the 10.
10 damage?
Yeah. So I get their attention.
Okay, your blade sinks into the breastplate, all the way up to the hilt. The armor staggers, and it turns towards you.
You
definitely heard it.
Right, last action I'm going to do.
Okay, hang on a second. Yep. Roll for initiative.
Oh, right.
All right.
Oh, would you know it? It's another one.
I got a seven.
I got lazy seven. After that. Dave, the FBI agent, is fucking with me right now. He's on the back end of this page, just like fucking up the random generator.
Okay, so, who was first?
I have 17.
17.
Red has 22.
Okay, we got, and cowboy. I got you. Christ, I got you. Cowboy, what'd you say you had?
22.
17.
17, okay. Next, Chroma, red.
I got a 4. I know.
Oh, this poor lady.
I can't hear you. Yeah. Can't hear you, Chroma.
You're muted.
Ten fingers, 10 toes.
10, okay.
Hey, don't rub it in.
Actually, it's funny because for me, I can have as many as I want.
Yeah.
Okay, so I got.
That's nice. God bless you with no, or only five.
Claudius at 22. Zorban at 17. Chroma at 10. 2 suits of armor, and then 5 figures. Thanks, you're up first. What would you like to do? Remember, you've had a long rest.
Yes, so I am back at full health now.
There's ball bearings out there, so step lightly.
You got it. Step of the wind.
So I am going to take... I'm going to take a short rest. sorry. I'm gonna hit him with my lawn sword.
Okay, give me a dexterity save to try to avoid the ball bearings.
Just time out. We need some Doritos.
Nutrition drink.
Okay, if you're attempting to do a melee attack of your sword, give me a dexterity save before your attack save because there's ball bearings on the floor.
So dexterity, I rolled a 9.
No bite.
I'm gonna go on a limb and say that's not good.
That's not good. So the dragonborn goes charging out there with the sword and goes.
I just showed you I did this.
He goes sliding down the hallway past Armageddon's. Acrobatics check, please.
Don't you have ranged weapon?
All right, acrobatics check. It's actually, I would hope it's going to be okay. Never mind, I'd rolled a 4.
You wind up flat on your back. Okay, that is your turn.
Oh,
Zorban, you are next.
How far are these
20 feet
knights?
20 feet away.
Are they a medium like build?
Yes, they are normal man size.
Alright, I'm gonna use Gust to take one of the normal man size knights and take the gust of wind, sending them flying 5 feet towards like the bearings on the floor.
Okay. The bearings are or at least 5 feet in close to you, and in the square they're at 5 feet beyond, and then there's the dragonborn.
So you're pushing the dragonborn along at higher velocities. Are you trying to go to a bowling ball?
I'm trying to blow one of the knights towards them so they go flying down the hallway.
Okay, in my space here. Right or left armor are you attacking? Armor would the left armor would be the closest to the dragonborn.
Yes, the left.
Okay, so roll your attack or whatever it is the gust of wind does.
Hey, it's
Is it a saving throw?
It says one medium or smaller creature that you choose must succeed on a strength saving throw or be pushed up to 5 feet.
And they fail. So, yes, they... let me check to see if they go prone. All right. So, yes, you've gusted the left suit of armor 5 feet away and landed flat on its back because of the ball bearings and your attack. So it will not be attacked, be able to attack this round. Anything else you'd like to do?
No.
Chroma, you're up.
Are the armors within 5 feet of each other?
Well, they were. They're not anymore.
Fair point.
No, they're about within 10 feet of each other now.
Alright, I'm just going to acid splash.
Okay, the one that's prone, which is dead sea, that would be 30 feet away. The one that is closer to you is 20.
I'll go for the one closest because that's closer to the Dragonborn.
Okay.
He has to do a...
No, the one closest to the Dragonborn is 30 feet away.
Oh, it's the prone one. Okay, yeah. Then he auto-fails.
Okay.
And at the 6, that's max damage. Look at that.
I'm confused. You said auto fail and then what, secondary attack? Is this what this is?
No. I did acid splash.
Right.
And he has to do a dexterity saving.
Oh, yes, which is an auto fail. Gotcha. All right. Yeah. What's your damage?
6. 6 acid damage. That's it. My whole turn.
Okay. Smoke and steam rises from the prone armored figure that is closest to Claudius. Anything else you'd like to do?
No, sir. That's it. Done for me.
Okay, so this armored figure cannot do anything this turn. So the next one draws his sword and starts marching towards you. He does a dexterity saving throw and fails horribly. Lands flat on his back, drops his sword. He is no longer able to do anything. Red, it is your turn.
Me. Hey, it's not me doing it, finally.
All right. Your ball bearings are saving the day.
Yeah, but I'm going to go there now. I don't want to lose my second dagger. And I'm going to walk nimbly up there and, dexterity.
Yeah, give me a dexterity saving throw to navigate your ball bearing field.
Do I fuck it up? Eight.
Give me an acrobatics roll as well, please.
You got it. Oh, yeah, it's better.
Okay, you managed 15. To stay on your feet, but it was tricky. You did step on a couple of ball bearings and did the deal. Whoa! But you managed to stay on your feet. And it takes your action.
My attack action?
Okay. Yeah.
From closer, right?
Yeah, you got within 5 feet of him, yes. But everybody's prone, so they can't attack you.
Cool. Alright, that takes my action then.
Okay. Claudius, Dragonborn, you're up.
Oh, goody.
Can he get it up?
Ballberg is like fucking yakety stacks shit, like.
Okay. Okay. Just to give you a description, you're flat on your back. There is a suit of armor close to you, within 5 feet, also flat on his back. There are ball bearings scattered all around you. So, take it from here.
And one of them is in a puddle.
I'm going to look to the side and use my breath weapon, since it doesn't involve me having to get up.
Okay.
So.
You might want to get up, though. And because you're at a disadvantage if they get up and hit you.
Dude, that's crazy. I didn't know that you could fire off without getting it up.
Hey, you know what? I may nice. You know what? I may be sure, but it's not my feet holding me up. And I rolled a 10.
Go get a
dagger. Thank you.
What else would hold you up?
Roll your damage, please.
I think 10 was his damage.
Was that, it was 10 your damage?
10 was my damage.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I mean, they auto failed.
That's too busy going off the short jokes. Okay. Electrical energy dances over the armor figure. It jerks and snaps around and collapses, but it still raises its head up and looks at you, so it's still alive.
Oh, goody.
A damn Terminator over here.
Zarbon, you are next. I'm sorry. Claudius, were you done? Anything else you'd like to do?
I end my turn.
Okay, thank you. Down. Zarbon, you are up.
Okay. No, I'll just pass and let the slime eat him.
So you're skipping your turn, is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, Chroma, you are up.
Do I feel like the acid was extra effective?
It was effective. That's all you could tell.
Alright, we'll try firebolt then.
The same suit of armor?
Same suit of armor. It's a dex saving throw. He's prone. Still, right?
Yep.
Still
prone? Yeah, it's not got up yet.
Roll my d10. That's 8 damage.
And that suit of armor collapses into nothingness. Just parts. Awesome. Let me get rid of this suit of armor.
I've ended my turn. Slow and steady wins the race. Let the ball bearings do the work.
Okay, so the second suit of armor attempts to stand up and collapses back on the floor, prone again. Red, it is your turn. Your ball bearings are being very effective, my friend. For everybody.
Is Cladus still on the ground?
Yeah, he's still prone. He chose not to stand up.
Can I get him up?
No, you would have to navigate your way over there. You managed to make your way close to the second set of armor, which is undamaged.
Right. Yeah, I'm going to fuck it up then. And I'm actually doing it on this app here. I actually don't have the roll for that. So, first order, here we go.
Yeah, you are within striking damage. Actually, you have advantage since he's still prone. So 11 is a miss if that was your attack.
And the other one is a 6 as the other advantage dice.
So your second attack was 6. So you're so you missed. Sorry.
I missed. Am I not out? I can still hit him one more time. Like. Can I just push him?
Oh, you want to kick him or something? Because he is prone.
Yeah, I want to get, if he's still, like, underneath, has ball bearings underneath him, I want to, like, kick him into, like, the door and have him, like, careen off into, like,
okay. Like, the wall. Okay, give it a melee attack.
You're gonna hit...
no, I stub myself.
poor Dragonborn.
I'm sure Austin say, Brad, he is really being graceful. Yeah, that's exactly what's going on. What did you roll, Brad?
I rolled a 5 to kick.
You did a whiff.
At least I didn't fall on my ass.
Yeah, no, give me an athletics check, please.
Oh, okay. Athletics or acrobatics?
Athletics.
That's an 11.
11. Okay, you managed to stay on your feet once more.
Yay.
Okay, back to the top of the initiative. Claudius, Kyle, it is your turn.
So the Dragonborn's still on his back. Is he mm-hmm.
I mean...
I'm hungry.
Okay, so I'm going to use my athletics to get up.
Okay. And you actually do not have to make a saving throw to stand up, and it's going to use your movement.
I'm going
to
stand.
Partial
okay,
movement.
I'm going to stand up.
Okay.
And I'm going to take a whack with my longsword.
Unfortunately, you're not within striking distance of the remaining suit of armor. You'd need to expend some movement, which will require a dexterity saving throw because of the ball bearings.
Okay, let's try this again. So I'm gonna make my move, my dexterity.
Show us your move.
I rolled a 7.
I'm sitting like a dog.
Okay, you make it about 5 feet. You hit the ball bearings and you give me a laugh. athletics or an acrobatics saving throw, whichever is better.
Maybe we should stop after this for the night. Yeah.
We gotta finish them off.
Okay, 24 athletics.
Oh, yeah, you managed to stay on your feet. You can continue your movement if you wish to.
Yes.
Okay, yes. You managed to make the rest of the move. You can attack the second set of armor should you choose so. He is prone, so you have advantage.
Okay, I'm going to take my long sword. I'm going to kill this guy.
I said the same thing.
16.
Well, you got an advantage, so roll again.
25.
Okay, that is definitely a hit. Was that a 20 and then added, or was it below 20?
Yeah, 20 plus 5.
Okay, so that is a critical hit. If you hit 20, then it's a critical hit. So whatever damage you do, double it.
Okay. So damage roll... rolled an 8, so 16.
16 points of damage. Oh, there it is. Okay. Took a big
better do
chunk.
Something, because I almost ended up on my ass twice.
You took off his left arm at the shoulder.
Oh, nice.
It's very slippy.
A little bit of cleave right there.
So, does that end your turn?
That ends my turn.
Zorban, you are up.
Yeah, I'm just gonna use Eldritch Blast.
Okay.
Attaboy.
I got a 22.
I didn't say hit, yes. And your damage
12
is
damage.
What's that?
12.
12. Okay, minus 12. Okay, as soon as the left arm separates at the shoulder, a bolt of Eldritch energy enters into the back and bursts out through the chest. The creature shudders. It still stands. Is there anything else you'd like to do?
Let's see. No, I'll end my turn there.
Okay, let's see. Chroma, you're up.
Okay. Boy, options. This is the last one, right?
Yes, it is the remaining suit of armor, yes.
Looks, is he still prone?
Oh, no, he's not. Well, yes, he's still prone. He has not stood up yet.
I got the safe way, or I got the wee ball way.
I don't think the bearings would mess up a slime, though, would they? Wouldn't they just, like, sink into him?
Mechanics-wise.
Yeah, mechanics-wise, he still has to grip the floor,
yeah,
so.
I have some things, though, that I could do, but how far away is he from me? I haven't moved since we started combat.
He's still 20 feet away. And flat on his back. So whatever you do will be an advantage.
He's 20 feet away and on his back.
Yep.
Okay. I am going to spend a key point.
Okay.
And get Step of the Wind. Now what this does is it doubles my jump and allows me to take the dash action.
Okay.
As a bonus action. So I have 80 feet of movement speed.
Okay.
And I can jump 22 feet.
Okay.
That's standing jump.
All right.
Jeez.
Yeah. So, I am going to just leap all the way over everything and land on top of him and then use my attack action to pummel the shit out of him.
Okay.
I see you jump over.
All right, here we go. You said I'm at advantage, right?
Yes.
He's prone. Okay. Ooh. Good thing. All right.
Excuse me.
19.
Okay, that's definitely is that a hit or is that your attack?
Attack action.
Okay. Yes, attack. That is definitely a hit.
All right. plus 4, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, as your feet... I'm sorry. Let me do this properly. You fly through the air, extending your pseudopods into like a kung fu movement, landing firmly on the body of the suit of armor. It burst at the seams. Parts fly everywhere. You land triumphantly on your feet at the remains of your victim. This creature is dead. Yeah. Very dead.
Excellent.
Initiative is over. Congratulations.
Can we stop up here for the night?
If you'd like to, yes.
That was fun.
Yeah, it was a good
Before we quit for the night, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go around and pick all the ball bearings up by shifting over them and then absorbing them. And then I'll like lit up my hand, my pseudopod like a hose will go into the bag and just pummel the ball back into Five Fingers' bag.
Okay, you're a Roomba, the ball bearings into the container.
We can do this again next time.
So the ball bearings turned out to be a boon and not so much of a boon, but they were effective.
I don't know why y'all decided to run into them.
Okay.
That's why I was like, I'm just going to make them run into me. Wind.
Yeah, that's what I did. I just was like, okay, cool. Range.
I just want to see what my skills could do.
This was definitely a very fun session. Anybody else want to... ask any questions or come up with something else before we end the stream or the recording?
I do have one other question. It's about the place. What was the place of this mine again? The name of the mine?
Kyton's mine. Kytons.
Cool. Thank you. Kytons.
Mm-hmm.
I'm tracking what we're finding so that way I can put things together. I'm thinking old boy in the tavern's a necromancer.
He's the nicest necromancer.
Anybody else?
Somebody's arm matches.
Yeah, no more ones, please. Thanks. I'd like you to just stop that.
Sorry, the dice say what the dice say. So.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, if there's nothing else, thanks everybody. Try this again. Thanks for everybody for playing with me tonight. Had a ball. The last little bit with the caverns of the shadows was really pretty much just pulled out of my ass. I'll have more of a map made up next time. Everybody who's watching on YouTube, thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next time. Good night, guys.